From Great American Ballpark in Cincinnati, Ohio, it's a beautiful evening for Chicago Cubs baseball on Comcast Sportsnet. Tonight, the Cubs try to end a season-long six-game losing streak as they play the Reds in Game 2 of this three-game weekend series. Hi again, everyone. Bob Brenly and Len Casper with you. It's been a big-time struggle for the Cubs, really all the way around, defensively, offensively, and with the pitching. A chance here to end the streak. And, Bob, let's go back to when this streak started. The Cubs had won seven in a row, and the standings have changed, but not actually that much.
Really not that much, considering how badly the Cubs have struggled over their last six ball games. You can see through August 30th, a six-and-a-half-game lead over the Brewers, and even with the struggles, the lead's still at four games going into play tonight.
Now some changes in the lineup. Reed Johnson's going to start in center for Jim Edmonds tonight, and Michael Hoffpower will get the start in right for the struggling Kosuke Fukudome.
Well, hopefully Michael Hoffpower will be the guy to jumpstart this Cubs offense. He had a tremendous year at AAA Iowa this year, driving in 100 runs, hitting 25 homers to go along with the 362 batting average in only 71 games.
And we'll hear more from Lou a little bit later. His point basically is the last 21 games, whoever produces is going to continue to play. Now the pitching matchup tonight, couple of right-handers, Jason Marquis for the Cubs and Johnny Cueto, the rookie, for the Reds.
Well, Johnny Cueto, this will be his fourth start against the Cubs this year. He hasn't pitched in nearly 2 weeks because of a bad right arm, and Jason Marquis coming off a real good outing against Houston when his offense just did not score for him.
So coming up, it'll be Jason Marquis, who's 5-3 with a 3.12 ERA on the road. He'll try to end the Cubs losing streak when we come back.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount with everyone.
You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
And now we've extended the discount through September 30th. Use it to get the 2008 Chevy Malibu with better city fuel economy than Accord and Camry. That's right. Get this 2008 Chevy Malibu LS for around $19,000.
So, you're a green person, but which shade? Confusing, isn't it? Well, True Value's Color Made Simple can help. With exclusive tools, trained professionals, and expert advice, finding your color will always be simple. Now let's talk purple. True Value's Color Made Simple.
Meeting the challenge since 1940.
Since 1961, Black Hawk Bank and Trust has been a proud partner with the Quad Cities community. Through nearly five decades, Black Hawk Bank has grown from one branch to a mature bank of 10 Illinois and 3 Iowa branches. We now serve Rock Island, Henry, and Scott counties. In May of 2008, Black Hawk Bank and Trust and Great River Bank became one. Together, we carry on the tradition of local ownership, family ties, and community banking. Choose the Chief and experience the security of banking with a safe, solid local bank that is not for sale.
Hi, everyone. Gail Fisher with you. We'll get you back out to Cincinnati for the first pitch, but first, a look at the top stories in Chicago sports today. College football all around. Illinois hosting Eastern Illinois in newly refurbished Memorial Stadium. The Illini wearing throwback uniforms as well. Second quarter, Illinois up 13-7. Juice Williams fakes the handoff, and he's going to keep it, and he plows his way in for an 8-yard run. Touchdown and a 2-point conversion failed, so it's 19-7 late in the half. 2-yard line, Williams keeps it again in the end zone for the score, 26-7, Illini at the break. Second half action now, Williams pitches it to Aurelius Ben, and he finds his way in the end zone. Illinois now up 33-7, they get their first win of the season, 47-21 the final over the Panthers. Ohio State hosting Ohio, second quarter, Bobcats driving. And the handoff to Dante Harden, who goes up the middle for 15 yards. He gets in the end zone. Ohio up 7-6 at the half. Third quarter now. A bad snap for the Buckeyes. Todd Beckman can't come up with it. Curtis Myers recovers the ball for Ohio in the end zone. That's a touchdown. They're now up 14-6. Ohio State in trouble. But they come back, down 14-12 from the two. Brandon Sain gets the ball and plows his way in. Buckeyes up 19-12. Later in the fourth, same score. Ray Small returning the punts, and he avoids the rush. Breaks free, and he is off to the races. A 69-yard punt return for the touchdown. Buckeyes avoid the scare. They top Ohio 26-14. And NU is about to kick off at Duke. Northern Illinois is playing at Western Michigan. Sports Night will have more tonight after Cubs postgame live. First pitch is coming your way after the break. Enjoy the game, everyone.
We've come to this island, and you'll never believe what we found. The internet. Seems it can't hide here either.
Simply insert the AT&T laptop connect card. You're connected at up to 3G speeds.
Email business proposals, access your customer database, all on the go. I'm Bill Curtis, and I've just found the internet.
The internet can't hide anymore. Switch to the network with the best coverage and get the AT&T Laptop Connect card for free.
Spell simplicity.
Simplicity. F-E-L-D-C-O. Simplicity.
Close enough.
Call 866-4-F-E-L. DCO.
Replacing your old windows, siding, and doors is simple. Just call Feldco for top quality at a low factory direct price. Installed by polite, hardworking professionals.
Simplicity.
Feldco.
For quality windows, siding, and doors, call 866 for Feldco.
I can't believe I'm beating Billie Jean King.
You're not beating me. In fact, you haven't even got a serve in.
Okay. You might want to take a gander at the scoreboard. Whoa. What's with the Geico sign, Billie Jean?
They're sponsoring all this.
I get it. I quit, but I get it. Oh, look at that. That's hilarious.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
We've created a Chicago destination that's truly unprecedented. A celebration for the senses. Where the night comes alive and stars electrify your soul. The all-new Horseshoe Casino, where entertainment knows no bounds. Now open.
I see skies of blue.
Some find it by mixing exercise with play. Some gain it by showing others the way, while others discover it in the beauty of nature. It's wellness. And at Blue Cross Blue Shield of Illinois, yours means the world to us. Because when it all comes together, we want to give you the inspiration to experience wellness everywhere.
What a wonderful world.
Cubs baseball on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in part by Chevy. Want to win World Series tickets? Text Cubs to 28546 for your chance to win, courtesy of Chevy. Midas, for brakes, oil changes, tires, and more, trust the Midas touch. Your Chicago area Lexus dealer, who invites you to test drive a Lexus today. Menards. At Menards, you'll find big lumber yards, big selection, and big savings. At Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, we want to give you the security to experience wellness everywhere. Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Cadillac, life, liberty, and the pursuit. And by Southwest Airlines. With Southwest Airlines, you're now free to be more productive. Visit southwest.com today.
Welcome back to Cincinnati. Both these managers have led both of these franchises. Lou Piniella, 14th on the all-time wins list, 1,689. Dusty Baker just tied Harry Wright for 35th on the all-time list, 1,225. Lou's 14th on that list. Sellout tonight here at Great American Ballpark, the fifth sellout of the season for the Reds. And a pretty different day. We saw a lot of sunshine today. We didn't see any of it yesterday. It rained throughout. We had a 17-minute rain delay before the first pitch, and the Cubs are hoping that the result will be much different after dropping game one 10-2.
Well, hopefully a normal pregame routine for both these ball clubs will bring out the best in the Cubs today. The teams had to hit in the cages yesterday. They were not able to get on the field here because of the rains you spoke of, but regular workout today, 80 degrees at game time, very comfortable humidity at 42%. The wind's out of the northwest at 9, doesn't figure to affect play here at this ballpark, and you couldn't ask for a more ideal forecast for a ball game.
And as always, we'll keep an eye on how the Brewers are doing tonight. A fantastic matchup in Milwaukee as Jake Peavy will pitch for the Padres, Ben Sheets for the Brewers. And again, the Cubs are 4 games up in the division. And the Reds are about ready to take the field behind rookie right-hander Johnny Cueto. Ran into a lot of Cubs fans the last couple of days. There's a lot of blue in this ballpark. And let's check in on the Cubs Southwest starting lineup. Again, they're trying to end a 6-game skid. Soriano will lead it off, Terrio's second. Lee Ramirez Soto 3-5. Michael Hoffpower getting his first career start as a right fielder. It's Mark DeRosa at second base, Reed Johnson in center batting eighth, and Jason Marquis, the pitcher, will hit 9.
Let's take a look at the Reds defensively. Behind Johnny Cueto tonight, Dickerson in left, Patterson in center, Jay Bruce over in right field, Encarnacion and Kepinger on the left side of the infield, Phillips and Votto on the right side. Paul Bacco, the veteran catcher, will be behind the plate tonight for the young right-hander, Johnny Cueto. He's looking for his 9th victory of the season. Mentioned his last outing was cut short against the Colorado Rockies, went only 3 innings, came out with soreness in his right triceps tendon. Good fastball, good changeup, an occasional slider. See the numbers on the season. Lefty-righty splits very nearly equal.
And now the Kia umpires, Brian Runge, part of a 3-generation umpiring family. His father Paul, his grandfather Ed were major league umps. And Brian's in his 10th year. He'll call the balls and strikes. Barry Gibson and the crew chief Relaford on the bases.
I caught many a game in front of Brian's father Paul Runge. For my money, one of the best ball strike umpires during the days that I played.
So the table's been set, and Alfonso Soriano will come up. He had an interesting night last night. He reached base 2 times out of 5, but he never did put a ball in play. 2 walks and 3 strikeouts.
Yeah, didn't have the greatest of approaches against Bronson Arroyo last night, but you have to give a lot of credit to Bronson Arroyo. That's probably as sharp as we've seen him in a long time last night, especially with that sweeping breaking ball.
So the 22-year-old right-hander deals, swing and a miss, strike 1.
And unlike Bronson Arroyo last night, when you get in fastball counts tonight, you're going to get a fastball from Johnny Cueto. He loves to challenge with that mid-90s fastball.
There's another one at 95. That one was a little bit too high. 1 ball, 1 strike. Hit foul right when we started last night. You asked for a moment of silence for your Ohio Bobcats. As you said, they were going to go to slaughter today, but it didn't work out that way. They lost to Ohio State by 12, but the way you looked at it, they won by 22.
That's
because
right.
They were 34-point underdogs. They blew them out.
If they'd have called the game at halftime, we would have won.
It's caught by Jay Bruce, 1 out. I turned on that game and it was 14-6 Ohio. They had a shot.
Well, unfortunately, that's where the depth of those major football programs really comes into play. When you're playing against an undermanned team, you eventually just grind them down. But a great showing today by the Bobcats. I'm proud of.
Hit foul by Ryan. Good numbers for him on the season. 5-10 with a couple of doubles.
You and only two strikeouts in those 10 at bats. Cueto, very much a strikeout pitcher.
This is his fourth start against the Cubs, 1-2 with a 3.66. The win came here on May 5th. Both losses have come in Wrigley Field.
And he actually pitched well enough to win one of those games at Wrigley. Went 7 innings, gave up 4 hits and only 1 earned run, but his team didn't score for him in a 5-0 loss.
Ontario with excellent numbers against the Reds in general, even though he went hitless last night. With a walk, he made the final out. A nice play by Corey Patterson in center. Brandon Phillips will throw out Ontario, 2 outs. And tonight's road telecast here on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in high definition by Sharp Aquas. And happy birthday to Derek Lee. He turned 33 today. And as always, we give him a slice of birthday cake. Graphically speaking, way inside on him. It's not a fun birthday present. Come on, Johnny. It's the man's birthday.
Put one on a tee for him right here.
Cueto 8-12 on the season. This is his 28th start. That is a fair ball for Derek Lee. It'll rattle around in the corner. And he's 1-for-1 with a double on his birthday. It's his 34th double of the season.
Right, maybe facing Johnny Cueto and his fastball is exactly what the Cubs needed offensively. We'll see as this game progresses. So Charlie Relliford looking right down at third baseline. In his estimation, that ball went right over the bag. The Cubs have seen a lot of finesse pitchers recently, a lot of guys who rely on their breaking stuff and their off-speed pitches to be effective. Johnny Cueto is going to challenge, as I said earlier.
They've also faced a lot of veterans. Cueto in his first year in the majors. Fastball strike to Ramirez. Like Derek, he has hit 12 home runs in this ballpark in his career. They are tied for third for the most home runs by a visiting player in this ballpark's history. Now you said it with the fastball. The Cubs are going to have to turn it up a notch after all those breaking balls for Bronson Arroyo last night. I guess there are two ways to look at it if you're Dusty Baker as far as how you would align these guys in your rotation. Well, you go with Arroyo first, kind of slow the bats down a little bit, then bring Cueto the next day. Or you could go Cueto and then speed him up and then bring in Arroyo the next night. But ideally, managers like to have that different style from one day to the next, whether it's righty lefty or in the case of Arroyo, the breaking ball specialist, and Cueto, the fireballing righty. Swing and the miss. He went with the heat to get Ramirez, and that'll end the top of the first. The Reds are coming up against Jason Marquis when we come back.
Closed captioning on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by Luna.
773-202-LUNA. Dames en heren, we gaan beginnen!
We'll be right back.
exceptionally brewed for a taste that's pure Amsterdam. Amstel Light, one damn good beer.
Hey Cubs fans, are you looking to get tickets to the hottest Cubs games this year? Visit Cubs.com and click on StubHub, the official fan-to-fan ticket marketplace of Cubs.com. Don't miss all the fun and excitement at the friendly confines with StubHub. There's always a ticket available to a Cubs game.
The Arby's Rescue Brigade trains for the 99 cent barbecue deal.
Brigade, the barbecue is back, and it's available for just 99 cents. Arby's classic oven-roasted beef smothered in tangy barbecue sauce. And at just 99 cents, there's no better time to try one.
You growing a mustache, Tuppy?
I found fun.
I like it.
Arby's is saving the world from ordinary fast food with a return of barbecue. Get yours for just 99 cents and try our delicious new orange cream swirl shake. It'll have you saying, I'm thinking Arby's.
You're watching the home of the Bulls, Blackhawks, Cubs, and White Sox, Comcast Sportsnet.
Well, as we said, Cubs fans have invaded Cincinnati. Yeah! And they're hoping the Cubs can end their long losing streak here tonight. Sellout crowd on hand here at Great American Ballpark. And now here's the Reds Southwest starting lineup. They're in fifth, 22 games out, but they've won five of their last seven. Chris Dickerson's hit in eight straight. Kepinger with two hits last night. Brandon Phillips hits third. Joey Votto with a huge night. Home run, he knocked in three. Encarnacion at third. Jay Bruce with his first career grand slam. It's former Cubs Corey Patterson and Paul Bacco, 7 and 8. Cueto hits ninth, and Jason Marquis is ready to go. And the outside corner for strike one on Dickerson. Marquis looking for his 10th win.
Those odd splits at the bottom. Lefties hitting only 245 against Jason Marquis. Right-handers 283. You would expect those numbers to be flip-flopped.
Dribble toward first. Marquis will shovel it to Lee to get the out. Didn't have a lot of time with Dickerson running, but they got him.
Well, the one thing you have to do defensively as a pitcher here is commit to what play you're going to make. Are you going to glove the ball and shovel it to Derek Lee? Are you going to barehand it? Are you going to try to scoop and tag? A lot of times that pitcher gets caught in between what play he should make, but that time Marquis went after it with the bare hand. Nice toss on to D. Lee for the first out.
Kepinger, the shortstop, ball one. Jason coming off a quality start, but it was a loss. Six innings against the Astros on Monday. Five hits, two runs, but the Cubs didn't score. They lost 3-0. The wind and the 2-0 pitch. That's a strike at the knees, 2-1.
I know we're only on the second batter of the ball game here for Jason Marquis, but he appears to have real good movement on that sinking fastball here in the early going.
Bounced up the middle. DeRosa will slow it down, but not knock it down, and that'll be a base hit for Kepinger. So he's 3-for-6 to start the series, and it'll bring up Brandon Phillips.
A lot of ground balls when Jason Marquis has his good sinker working. Unfortunately, this one just beyond the reach of Mark DeRosa at second base, only able to knock it down. Can't make a play.
So Kepinger's double play partner at the plate, 1-for-6 in his career against Marquis. First time Jason has faced the Reds this season. He's 5-3 in his career in 13 previous appearances, including 12 starts, a high 5.06 ERA. That's hit foul off to the right. Well, it's only the first inning, but you start thinking about the Reds lineup, who's hot, who's not, and you want to get Phillips because Joey Votto, who has killed the Cubs this year, is on deck. And he's hitting over 450. Over his last 11 games, he hit a two-run homer to get things going for the Reds last night. Terrio, DeRosa, Lee, and Votto will head back into the dugout and grab his glove. So Marquis doesn't have to face him with anybody on. After one, nothing, nothing.
Celebration of our 100th anniversary.
We're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone. You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on Buick Enclave with better fuel efficiency than Acura MDX. And right now, you can get a Buick Enclave starting at just $29,950. Offer ends September 30th.
I see skies of blue.
Some find it by mixing exercise with play. Some gain it by showing others the way. While others discover it in the beauty of nature. It's wellness. And at Blue Cross Blue Shield of Illinois, yours means the world to us. Because when it all comes together, we want to give you the inspiration to experience wellness everywhere.
What a wonderful world.
Welcome back to Cincinnati. No score in the top of the second. Chris Bowden with you. This losing streak started a week ago, and yes, Cubs fans, Lou is anxious to see it end as well. And before the game, vowed in making his lineup the rest of the way, he says it's going to be an equal opportunity situation these final 3 weeks.
These last 20 games or 21 games, I'm going to try to play a lineup that can win a ball game that day. That's what I'm going to do. I mean, I played everybody all year. Everybody's gotten opportunities over here. And now we're going to try to play a lineup that can win a baseball game that particular night. And if these guys want to stay in the lineup, I mean, swing the bats. I mean, the opportunity's there for a kid like Kauf Power. I've got Reed Johnson in center field. I mean, you know, he gave us a spark earlier. We're going to give him a chance and see what he does. And we mix and match, but we got to start scoring some runs on a little more consistent basis than we have here over the past week. And then we got to get our rotation back set so that we can get our bullpen set again. I mean, let me tell you, when it rains, it pours. Well, it's pouring right now, I can tell you.
And Len, the first tweak to that lineup is in the on-deck circle right now. Back to you.
Thanks, Chris. Yeah, talking about Michael Hoffpower. I thought Lou said it all. This thing has now gone on for 6 games. And it's all about production. And we've said that really about Lou since the day he took the job. Encarnacion will play the two hopper and throw out Giovanni Soto.
Well, I think Lou sent a couple of different messages. Number one, to guys like Reed Johnson and Micah Hoffpower and others, if you get in that lineup and make something happen, you're going to get more at-bats and more playing time. For those of you who have been in the lineup and have not been producing, you better kick it in gear quickly or you're going to end up sitting next to Lou on the bench watching the last 3 weeks of the season.
So an opportunity here for Hoffpower, who has just basically hit pitching everywhere. Triple-A, the majors, it hasn't really mattered.
Well, this should be a good opportunity for Micah tonight. I mean, the little bit we've seen of him at the major league level this year, where he's hit 368, by the way, he can handle anybody's fastball. Tremendous fastball hitter. When he gets into trouble is when he faces those finesse pitchers that drop some breaking balls in fastball counts, throw straight changeups, and that gives everybody some problems.
Foul tip strike. Well, there's opportunities now for guys like Hoffpower and Reed Johnson. I don't think Lou would use the word pressure, And they're going to check it. He went around and didn't run. And then Bacco tags him out. Well, Micah thought that he held up, but they appealed down to third base. Charlie Rutherford said he swung at it. Bacco located the ball and didn't have to make a throw.
That's a tough one as a hitter. You don't want to concede and run down that first baseline. You just hope that the third base umpire does not ring you up on appeal. Unfortunately, that time Charlie Rutherford said that Micah went too far, and Bacco had the ball right there to apply the tag.
Now it's Mark DeRosa, who's hit over 400 against the Reds since he became a Cub last year. Lou probably wouldn't use the word pressure, but while there's an opportunity for a guy like Michael Hoffpower, if he doesn't take advantage of it pretty quickly, Lou will move on to the next thing, whether that's put Kosuke right back in the lineup or give somebody else a chance. Including tonight, Bob, there are only 21 games left in the season, so it's not as if Lou announced, hey, Mike is my guy. It was very generic. If you produce, you will play. That's just the nature of the beast at this point. Popped up by DeRosa. Phillips goes out, and he will make the basket catch running away from home plate. A very difficult play, and he made it look easy. Cubs go down in order in the second after an inning and a half. No score.
I'm feeling fine. Whenever you shine.
They say the sun shines a little brighter in Florida. See why. Fly Southwest Airlines from Chicago Midway to the Sunshine State for just $89 or $99 one way. Go to southwest.com/Florida to book your trip today.
You are now free to move about the country.
Coors Light on tap. Because if you want an ice cold draft, look no further than ice cold frost brewed Coors Light. It's aged cold, filtered cold, and stored cold. Brought to your bar and poured cold. So ask for a draft beer with a taste as cold as the Rockies, because refreshment isn't everything. It's the only thing. Frostbrewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
Hi, I'm Scott, and this is Jim, the voice of Lexus, to tell you about the IS.
Treat yourself to a ride in the IS, and you will be enveloped. With its sumptuous exterior, perforated leather, including a leather trim shift knob, a leather shift tip top.
See your Chicago area and Northwest Indiana Lexus dealer.
Cubs baseball is brought to you in part by Kia Motors. Kia, the power to surprise. Rico, move your ideas forward with Rico dependability. And by Nissan and your Nissan dealer.
Aramis Ramirez is on board for the Universal Orlando Chicago Cubs trip. Join him, All-Star Giovanni Soto, Mark DeRosa, Ryan Terrio, Lee Smith, Hall of Famers Billy Williams and Fergie Jenkins, and many more. Fans will have unprecedented up-close access to the players you can't get anywhere else. For more info, call AAA Travel at 1-866-YOUR-AAA or go to AAA.com. We'll see you in December. Joey Votto pulls it foul on the ground.
A little upset, Len. That guy with the binoculars over there on the riverbank supposed to be watching my pole. I left it over there earlier today.
What can you catch in the mighty Ohio?
Well, I know they have catfish in there as big as a pickup truck. Other than that, I don't really know. I've never really fished in the Ohio River, but I'm sure there's some good fish in there.
One and two the count. Here's a pitch by Marquis. Check swing, but Votto held.
Now, Votto will chase the high fastball. We saw him do it in the ball game last night a couple times. We saw him do it at Wrigley earlier this year. If you get ahead in the count, you can expand that strike zone vertically, go up above the letters, and he will chase that pitch from time to time.
The Menard's big lumber stat, he supplied it last night. 2-2. And that's a foul ball.
I heard it.
As Soto thought he simply swung and missed at it, but I definitely heard the bat hit the ball before it hit the dirt. No argument from the Cubs dugout.
Good change up down. Yeah, he definitely deflected that ball. It changed the path.
Marquis rocks and fires. That one's dribbled foul. Still 2-2. The Reds have already been eliminated from division title contention. Their tragic number, as you sometimes hear, with regard to the wild card is 4. It's a combination of Brewers wins and Reds losses. Votto thrown out by Ryan Terrio. 1 out. Well, Milwaukee beat the Padres last night in 11 innings. J.J. Hardy with an RBI single to win it. So that series tied at 1 apiece. They're scoreless in the top of the third tonight in game 3. Called strike on Encarnacion. The Dodgers have jumped past the Diamondbacks and into first in the National League West with a 7-2 win in L.A. There's a base hit into center.
Well, then you talked about Joey Votto and how hot he's been against the Cubs this year and in the ball game last night. But for Jason Marquis personally, the guy that's on first base right now has been his nemesis. Edwin Encarnacion, 7 for 14 lifetime with a couple of home runs.
Rookie Jay Bruce, who hit his first career grand slam in game 1. Came off John Lieber in the 4th inning. So who was hitting balls off the smokestacks out in right center? Was it Bruce or Votto?
It was Votto in batting practice today. He put on quite a display. After taking his round where you hit the ball to the opposite field, then you work on hooking the ball to the right side, and then those last 10 swings or so, he was just peppering that imitation riverboat out there in right center, including high off the smokestack. That is a blast.
Marquis kind of fell off the mound. I'll have you know, sir, that is an authentic imitation riverboat. It's not a fake fake.
Yeah.
3-0 pitch way outside, ball 4.
Well, if you listen to the pitchers on this Reds ball club, they would like to close the gap on the third base side of the field behind home plate. There's an opening that you can see out into downtown Cincinnati, and the general consensus among pitchers is the wind comes in that gap and blows straight out to right field. There you see the opening, and there seems to be a jet stream consistently blowing out to right field, and this is a very cozy ballpark to begin with. And a lot of the Reds pitchers feel if they could close that gap somehow, it would improve their chances of keeping the ball in the ballpark.
Patterson grounds out to second base. Second and third, 2 gone. So one former Cub made it out. Here comes another, Paul Bacco. Yeah, this has been an offensive ballpark from day one. No question about it. And now Soto will go out and chat with his pitcher.
Now, this is definitely a pitch-around situation. Paul Bacco not having a great offensive year by any stretch of the imagination, hitting only 204 coming into play tonight. But you have a base open down there at first, and Johnny Cueto, the pitcher in the on-deck circle, is 1-for-38 this season. So if you are going to pitch to Bacco, pitch him extremely careful. If you walk him, you walk him, you go after the opposing pitcher.
Here's the 1-0, and that's off the corner.
I think they're going to go ahead and put him on now. That's always a dangerous proposition, trying to pitch around somebody, especially a veteran like Paul Bacco. He understands the situation here, and he's likely to go out of the strike zone if you try to pitch around him and could possibly shoot one through that left side of the infield. So just take the bat completely out of his hand.
Well, in talking about this ballpark, you think about the free agent signing of Eric Milton, which did not go well. He wasn't really healthy, but when he was, he really struggled. Fly ball pitcher in an intimate ballpark. I guess their theory is, you know, maybe bring sinker ballers here, keep the ball on the ground. I think the best thing, and they've talked about it at Coors Field, is you can strike people out, miss bats. That's probably the best way to approach pitching in this ballpark. Don't even let them put it in play.
And avoid the base on balls. That pretty much goes for any ballpark, but especially a cozy little yard like this where a base on balls or two could lead to a big inning.
Cueto pops it up, and it will be caught by Reed Johnson. He had a beat on it from the moment it left the bat, and the Reds leave the bases loaded. Still no score as we go to the third.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount with everyone.
You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
And now we've extended the discount through September 30th. Use it to get the 2008 Chevy Silverado with better available V8 fuel economy than Tundra and F-150. That's right. Get this 08 Silverado half ton for around $20,500 after all offers.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
Is the batting in a color?
Uh-huh.
Let's start with some idea cards. That'll get you to the right one.
We're here because we've been there with the tools, products, and advice to get it done right. True Value. Start right. Start here.
Get the right products and expert advice for your next painting project at K&K True Value. Start right. Start here.
Have you seen the selection of trailers at the Trailer Depot in Clinton? The area's best kept secret and the best prices on trailers are at the Trailer Depot. Buy new, buy used, or rent. Trailer Depot has any trailer you need. We even make repairs, sell parts, and get your vehicle ready to tow. Knowing what you're towing keeps us growing at Trailer Depot. Behind you on the road and ahead of the competition. 7th Avenue South in Clinton.
No score as we head for the top of the third. Coy Hill came in the ballgame last night in the sixth inning as a defensive replacement. And he promptly doubled into the gap in left center field. Our AT&T delivered. Coy Hill went 2-for-2. That double, also a single. The only two Cubs hits that reached the outfield last night of their six.
Cubs fans young and old here in Cincinnati as Reed Johnson, who's batting eighth, will lead off the Cubs third. Jason Marquis and Alfonso Soriano also due up. Cubs with one hit through two. That was a double by Derek Lee in the first. Swing and a miss. I ask you this a lot. We can ask Reed later. Was he expecting a fastball and didn't get it?
I think that's exactly what happened. I mean, Johnny Cueto has challenged every Cubs hitter so far with a first pitch fastball. Reed Johnson has been doing his homework, paying attention. He went to the plate looking for that first pitch fastball, tried to ambush the Reds right-hander, and he threw him a slider instead.
It seems to be, in watching pitchers work, pitchers who've had success, pitchers who haven't, that what every guy tries to do is stay away from a pattern. Because if you do generally get into some sort of pattern, opposing teams will figure it out. It's not that difficult as Johnson grounds out the third. And as a former game caller, what's the secret to not having a pattern? I mean, it's easier said than done. I would think even catchers get into some sort of habit or pattern.
Oh, it certainly happens. I mean, a lot of it depends on what your pitcher has working on a given night. If he's got all of his pitches working, then you can really mix up that first pitch and avoid those guys going to the plate sitting on a first pitch fastball. But by the same token, if he's got good command of that fastball and you put it in a location where the batter can't hit it hard, he's liable to put it into play anyway and make a quick, easy out.
So it's not just pitch selection, but it's location as well.
Absolutely.
Yep. And Jason pretty late on that swing. Nothing in two.
I mean, for all these years, 20-plus years that Tom Glavine has been pitching in the major leagues, everybody knows he's going to throw you fastballs on the outside corner, but he consistently executes his pitch and gets a lot of easy outs, even though guys know it's coming.
Yeah, that's an excellent point. This is going to be just out of play. Yeah, the best ones, oftentimes, you know exactly what's coming, but you can't do anything about it.
And the reality is, if major league pitchers never made mistakes, nobody would ever hit. Every game would be extra innings, 1-0. But pitchers make mistakes. And the good hitters take advantage of those mistakes.
Bounced foul as Jason's hanging in there. Again, Cueto is just 22 years old. You see the stuff. It's really good. Lined, and it'll be caught as Dickerson had to leave his feet. It still was a very good at bat for Jason Marquis. Didn't look very good on the first two swings when he missed, but he was able to foul off a few pitches and should have ended up with a hit.
Yeah, nice swing right there. A lot of risk, gets good carry. Unfortunately, too much carry all the way out to Chris Dickerson in left field, who makes a nice diving catch coming straight in.
Transportation. The CTA offers a variety of.
There's a deep drive to left, and the Cubs will get the lead. Gone! Soriano with his 25th home run on a 1-0 pitch, and really there was no doubt about it. Well, it looks to me, Bob, like about 7 out of every 10 fans are rooting for the Cubs here tonight.
All right, Belvedere going downtown. Home run replay after pushing Fonzie off the plate with a fastball up and in. He tries to sneak one more past him on the inside part of the plate, and Alfonso will have nothing to do with that.
Ryan Terrio shoots it into center. So the Cubs jumpstart their offense with a home run. Not a big surprise for a team that does hit a lot of home runs. when the Cubs fans really into it. They never had a chance to get into it last night. The home run for Soriano means he has sole possession of the team lead with 25, even though this is just his 93rd game.
Well, this could turn into a raucous evening here at Great American Ballpark. Yeah, the Cub fans finally have a reason to cheer here, second game of the series, and even though it appears it's mostly Cub fans out there, there's a lot of Reds fans in the house too, and they want to try to shout down the Cubby fans.
One strike on D. Lee. Another check on Terrio.
Cueto throwing 95 to the plate, 92 to first base in that pickoff attempt.
The kick and the pitch. Not hit very hard. Kepinger will throw on to first to end the inning. But the Cubs grab the lead as Alfonso Soriano goes deep to left, and it's 1-0 Cubs.
The Chicago Cubs strongly encourage the use of public transportation. The CTA offers a variety of options, including the Red Line, which stops right at Wrigley Field at the Edison Station. If you must drive, try the remote parking operation at DeVry University, located near the Edison and Rockwell intersection. The remote lot offers parking and an express bus for just $6. For more details, call the CTA hotline at 773-836-7000 or visit cubs.com.
Exceptionally brewed for a taste that's pure Amsterdam. Amstel Light, one damn good beer.
It's Toyota's National Clearance Event, the perfect time for amazing deals and selection. Check out Camry, the number one selling car in America. Or the fuel-efficient Corolla, a lot of car for the money. And there's Tundra, Motor Trend's 2008 Truck of the Year. Or the Tacoma, with an impressive 26 miles per gallon highway rating. Hurry in today. The Toyota National Clearance Event ends soon.
Every Thursday, no other show goes more in-depth on your Chicago Bears than Countdown to Kickoff. Join Pro Bowl cornerback Nathan Vasher and 85 Bear Tom Thayer as they break down every angle before the weekend's big matchup. Countdown to Kickoff, every Thursday at 11, only on Comcast Sportsnet.
Sign up for a subscription to Vineline, the official monthly magazine of the Chicago Cubs. Vineline offers exclusive player features, team analysis, and minor league coverage. In print and now available online through the Cubs Club on Cubs.com. Visit the Cubs official website to order Vineline today. So Jason Marquis working with a 1-0 lead as he faces the top portion of the Reds order. A 1-0 pitch to Dickerson is downstairs. 2-0. Well, the Cubs didn't lead last night. They got shut out Wednesday 4-0. So I believe this is their first lead since that 9-7 loss in 11. And Soto heads out. 3-0 the count. Cubs, I know, led 1-0 in that game Tuesday. What do you think Gio's telling Jason here?
Jason obviously had something on his mind there after that last pitch and called Gio out to the mound, wanted to talk it over with him. I'm not sure exactly what this could be. In a 3-0 count, obviously you just need to get back in the sequence here with a good quality strike, but it was a rather long conversation before a 3-0 pitch.
Well, whatever he said worked. 3-1. Just throw a strike. Yeah. Okay. Check swing foul. And the Cubs had a couple of leads on Tuesday, but none since before Soriano hit the home run here in the third.
Could be a change up.
And Derek Lee will get it. Marquee covering. So nice comeback.
A 3-2 changeup is good against a young hitter. He sees that arm action. He sees the pitch come out of your hand. It looks like a fastball to him. He starts at bat and then in that instance rolled over, hit the easy ground ball to Derek Lee.
Here's a pitch to Kepinger. Hit foul near the plate. Fourth round pick of the Pirates out of the University of Georgia in 2001. This is his third major league team. Kepinger's had time with the Mets, the Royals, and now the Reds. Soriano will come in and he makes a catch. Little slide at the end. Nicely done. Two outs.
A hooking, sinking line drive to left field. Kepinger gets out around a sinker that was away from him. And nice running catch by Fonzie. Very similar to the one that Chris Dickerson made coming in the last half inning on the ball that Marquee hit.
Marquee faces Phillips with two outs and nobody on, and he rolls it up the middle for a base hit. So they have a single in each of the first three innings. And Marquee has to face Joey Votto with the man on and two down. Milwaukee getting a run in the bottom of the third, leading the Padres 1-0.
Saw that shot of Jason Marquee looking up at the big screen here at the ballpark, and talk about immediate feedback. I mean, the hitter will give you immediate feedback when you make a bad pitch, but then you look at the replay on the big board and Jason just shook his head, knew he made a mistake in the middle of the plate.
He'll pick it up with the bare hand, the lob to Lee in plenty of time, and the Cubs lead after 3-1-0.
Make Menards your one-stop shop for everything you need to prepare your home for the upcoming winter. Keep things warm with a new fireplace from Comfort Glow. This 32-inch direct vent fireplace with oak surround and base comes with a gas log set and LP conversion kit. Just $999. Protect windows, doors, and more with quad sealant from OSI. This all-weather exterior sealant stays flexible, won't fade, and has excellent adhesion to most surfaces. In six colors, only $397.
Save big money at Menards.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount with everyone.
You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on Pontiac G6 with better combined fuel efficiency than Honda Accord. And right now, you can get a G6 sedan starting at just $16,720. Offer ends September 30th.
We've come to this island, and you'll never believe what we found. The internet. Seems it can't hide here either.
Simply insert the AT&T Laptop Connect card. You're connected at up to 3G speeds. Email business proposals. Access your customer database. All on the go. I'm Bill Curtis, and I've just found the internet.
The internet can't hide anymore. Switch to the network with the best coverage and get the AT&T Laptop Connect card for free.
Wednesday, it's absolute arch madness as the Cubs light up the I-55 rivalry with a match against Albert Pujols and the St. Louis Cardinals, followed by Lowe's Cubs post-game live. Cubs starts in HD Wednesday at 7 on Comcast Sportsnet. Fans' best friend.
Time for tonight's Aflac trivia question.
Aflac!
Which Reds pitcher defeated the Cubs for the Reds' last win at Synergy Field on September 14th, 2002? Don't know the answer. I could take a guess at it. Do you have any thoughts?
No.
Could it have been Ryan Dempster? I'm just trying to make the Cubs-Reds connection. He would have been a Red late in 2002. Strike one on Aramis Ramirez.
I still have problems with the Synergy Field. It'll always be riverfront to me. Even though they took out the turf and put in the grass and tried to make it a different looking ballpark, it will always be riverfront to me.
Most memorable moment for you at riverfront?
Well, I got my first major league hit at Riverfront.
There you
stadium.
Go. That
yeah.
works.
And darn near the entire population of Coshocton, Ohio was in the ballpark that night.
Oh, that's perfect.
Yep.
How did it feel?
Oh, I tell you, you hear players talk about it all the time. You don't even feel your feet touching the ground as you're running around the bases. You know, it's just you're trying to focus on what you have to do, like Aramis Ramirez did right there, lining one back up the middle of the field. But there's so many thoughts running through your head. You know, you have a lot of friends and family in the stands, including a lot of people who made sacrifices so you could get to that position, and it was just a tremendously gratifying feeling.
Do you still have the baseball?
Yes, indeed, I do.
And tell us what it says on there.
Well, I have both baseballs, as a matter of fact. I can tell you what the real one says. You know, it has the date, the score of the ball game, the opposing pitcher, the count, the inning, and first major league hit. And then the other one, where they always, you know, mock up one and put it in your locker, has all kinds of profanity on it and various other unsavory things.
So it was the second game of a doubleheader, correct? Does that sound right to you or not? That's what I'm seeing here.
I just remember that Mike Lacoste was the starting pitcher for the Reds that day. And after he came out of the ball game, I got my hit off of a gentleman named Scott Brown, right-handed pitcher.
Yeah, it was the second game of a doubleheader.
See, I told you I like those doubleheaders.
August 14th, 1981. Reds won the game 7-6 in 10 innings. And Giovanni Soto finds a right field corner. Ramirez on his way to third. We'll see if Mike Quadi's going to send him. He's going to hold him up. Second and third, no outs. Cubs have it cooking here in the fourth inning, already up 1-0.
A possible chance to score Ramirez from first base, but this ball takes a perfect hop off the fence. Watch it come right back to Jay Bruce. Well, actually, you couldn't see it, but it bounced right up into his bare hand. Fielded it cleanly, and Mike Quadi had to throw up the stop sign for Aramis Ramirez as he labored between second and third. Now you'll see this ball come off the fence and ricochet right to Jay Bruce in the bare hand. That eliminated any chance of Ramirez scoring.
The Reds will concede a run. They're going to play back on the infield with Hoff Power at the plate. And while Micah's number one job is to get Ramirez home, he wouldn't mind a 2-for-1. He can hit the ball somewhere to the right side and get Soto to third as well. He's just trying to drive the ball here in this spot. Hits it right to the shortstop, Kepinger. That will get the run in. Soto had to go back to second, but Ramirez scores. It's an RBI for Hoffpower, his second career run knocked in, and it's 2-0 Cubs.
Micah took a pitch out away from him, hit it right on the button on one hop to Kepinger at short. Fortunately, the Reds were playing their infield back. Ramirez is able to trot home with the second run of the game for the Cubs.
Two DeRosa rolls one to Kepinger. Soto went right back to second base.
Quick at bat from Mark DeRosa. We ask around and couldn't really get a definitive answer on a possible pitch count for Johnny Cueto tonight. We mentioned he hadn't pitched in a couple of weeks, and as near as I can figure, between 80 and 100 pitches, and they'll probably err on the side of caution. If there's any question at all, they'll get him out of there sooner rather than later.
Yeah, Dusty was asked why the Reds wouldn't just shut him down, and I think that got Reed Johnson. It did. So that'll bring up the pitcher marquee.
And then we've seen several of these from Johnny Cueto in this ball game tonight. Soriano was pushed off the plate earlier. Derek Lee saw a pitch up and in, and this one just catches a piece of Reed Johnson's uniform.
12th time he's been hit.
And the 12th hit batter of the season for Johnny Cueto. Reed Johnson hasn't been all 12 of those, but he's one of them.
Marquis hits it high and very deep, but it's not going to carry enough. Right on the edge of the warning track. I'll tell you, Marquis has driven the ball well both times up against Johnny Cueto. Cubs add to their lead. It's now 2-0.
Everything okay, Carl?
I'm winning, right?
Yeah, but the other drivers think Aflac sponsorship's giving you an advantage.
Aflac pays cash fast to help keep you in the race.
I know, but they see it a little differently. I taught him that.
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Toyota Moving Forward is more than just a slogan. It's the way it is. Hello, I'm Bruce Dickstein of David Bruce Toyota. Toyota's having a remarkable year. The reason? Toyota builds superior vehicles, vehicles like this.
Lease a new 09 Toyota Corolla LE for $179 per month for 36 months or buy for only $16,899.
David Bruce Toyota delivers a buying experience and an atmosphere based on trust and respect that keeps our customers coming back.
Coors Light on tap. Because if you want an ice cold draft, look no further than ice cold frost brewed Coors Light. It's aged cold, filtered cold, and stored cold. Brought to your bar and poured cold. So ask for a draft beer with a taste as cold as the Rockies, because refreshment isn't everything. It's the only thing. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
And let's answer tonight's Aflac trivia question. Which Reds pitcher beat the Cubs for the Reds' last win at Old Synergy Field, which was right next door to this place on September 14th of 02? I got one right.
Good guess, partner.
Ryan Dempster. Brant Brown hit a home run, the only run Dempster allowed. Struck out 10 Cubs in that ball game. The Reds won 3-1. So the Cubs lead this one 2-0 as Marquis has had a good night at the plate, even though he's 0-for-2. We'll face Edwin Encarnacion to begin the last of the fourth. Well, the Cubs, and I know their fans everywhere, just want to experience that feeling that was very familiar up until 6 days ago. And that is that winning feeling. Would be their 86th win of the year. Still a long way to go. Swing and a miss on a slider from Marquis.
Was that a Righteous Brothers song? You've lost that winning feeling?
Yeah, something like that. That one in the dirt, they'll get a new ball.
Seen a lot of straight changeups from Jason Marquis already in this ball game, and as I mentioned earlier, I think that's a real good pitch against this young, aggressive Reds offense. A lot of free swingers. looking to sit on fastballs. If you can throw that straight change up close to the zone, you're liable to get a lot of easy outs. There's another one.
Encarnacion was way out in front. Well, Marquis has fared a lot better on the road than at home. His earned run average away from Wrigley, 3.12. It's 5.5 at home. Went with a fastball that time, and it was just off the plate, 3-2. Two games over on the road, one under at home. And try to paint the outside corner. But Encarnacion goes the other way with it. Jason's not happy with himself. Well, that's about as upset as you'll see Marquis.
Now this could be a cumulative snap on the part of Jason Marquis. I mentioned Encarnacion with real good numbers against Jason in his career. Now 8-for-15 with that base hit through the right side.
Jay Bruce walked his first time. A highly touted rookie. Played center when he came up in late May. That's because they had Adam Dunn in left and Ken Griffey Jr. in right. Rainbow into center. Johnson's first move was back. Now he comes in and it's going to be caught by Terrio. What a play by Ryan Terrio as Johnson was fooled. Reed went back and he was not going to have a play on it. Excellent catch by Terrio.
I don't think Reed Johnson ever saw that ball off the bat. You can see his arms out to his side. That's kind of the universal sign. I don't see it. Fortunately, Terrio continues to go after the ball. That's what infielders are taught to do. Go until you hear somebody call for it. Ryan never heard Reed Johnson, so he continued out there and made a nice snow cone catch in shallow center.
Patterson grounded out his first time. Fastball strike. Marquis hasn't had much trouble with Patterson, who's 3-for-18 against him. Jason was holding the ball in that changeup grip before he put it in the glove. Throws a slider that's inside.
Dusty Baker's taken some heat here locally from some of the writers and the radio shows for playing Corey Patterson and Paul Bacco as much as he has here late in the season. As you mentioned, the Reds have been mathematically eliminated. And I think a lot of people feel like Dusty should be playing the young players. Ryan Hannigan got the start behind the plate last night. Dickerson played center field. Hobart Cabrera played left field. But Corey Patterson, Paul Bacco, both in the lineup here tonight. I mean, the feeling is Corey Patterson's probably not going to be on this team next year, and Paul Bacco is iffy at best as a backup catcher, so why not play the youngsters, see what you have in store for next year.
Again, the Reds have won 5 of their last 7. You come in 15 games under 500 as Marquis walks Patterson. Now it's Bacco who was intentionally walked to get to Cueto the last time around. That was in the second. Key to the belt, deep breath, the pitch. Slicing, and it's going to drop down, and they're going to hold the runner at third base. Bases loaded with Cueto coming up. Well, Mark Berry had to make a very quick decision. He knows Soriano can throw guys out at the plate. He also knows he has a pitcher coming up. he decided in the end to not take any chances.
Now maybe with two outs in the inning, he can take a shot right there, but with only one out, I think Mark Berry did the right thing as far as the Reds are concerned. Soriano had a lot of momentum headed toward home plate and unleashes a pretty good throw. You see Ramirez pointing at second base. Corey Patterson had rounded the bag hard out there at second, expecting Mark Berry to send Edwin Encarnacion on home, and when he didn't, Patterson was caught between the bases briefly.
Corner man in just in case, a squeeze, swing and a miss.
And one thing on that play that kind of went unnoticed, but I guarantee you Larry Rothschild saw it. Jason Marquis was standing almost side by side with Giovanni Soto near home plate as that throw came in. His job is to get behind the plate, back up the play should that ball get through Gio. It didn't figure into that particular play, but that's a mental error that you cannot afford to make. Now you'll see where Jason Marquis is as this ball short hops, tough short hop into Giovanni Soto. If that ball gets away from him, Encarnacion could score and both Reds runners move up another base.
The kick in a 1-1. That's a foul ball. 1-2. Corner men are going to stay in. Try to cut down Encarnacion. They're in double play depth up the middle. Bases loaded, one out. Cubs lead 2-0. We're in the bottom of the fourth. Here's the pitch. Called strike three. Cueto slams his bat down.
Backdoor sinker from Jason Marquis right on the outside corner. Not sure why Johnny Cueto is so upset. That's probably the best result he could hope for. At least he didn't hit into a double play.
You think players are going to be a little extra careful with how they handle frustration when it comes to their bats after the Carlos Quentin injury? I guess it's something he had done a lot, punching his bat. He ended up with a broken wrist. You never did that, right?
No. I never punched my bat. That's a battle you're going to lose every time.
He slammed the fist on top of the bat. According to the Tribune story by Mark Gonzalez. The 1-0 pitch, low and inside. Two balls, no strikes on a guy who's been hot. Dickerson came in with an 8-game hitting streak. He is 0-for-2. Both outs have been ground outs. And he's in the driver's seat right now with the bases loaded. Missed again. Marquis really wanted it. 3-0. You be the judge.
Yeah, probably a little bit high, plus he missed his spot by about 3 feet.
That's.
Oh, man.
What's the call? Isn't that ball four? I was going to say, are we going to have a ball five situation?
Where's that pitch? Oh, come on.
Boy, Marquis is very upset, and he better watch it, or Brian Runge's going to toss him, and now the entire infield. And ahead to the mound as Lou Piniella walks out. Dickerson didn't go to first base.
That's because he knew that pitch was in the strike zone. I mentioned it earlier. Jason has a lot of late movement on his sinker today, but that 3-0 pitch certainly looked like it was all over the plate at the knees.
This is the most outward frustration I think we've seen from Jason since he's become a member of the Cubs. Not just that pitch. He's been upset at himself.
Remember, it's not where Gio catches the ball. I mentioned that late movement. When that pitch crossed the front of home plate, it was knee high. And Gio even turns around and asks Brian Runge where it missed. Now Lou's going to stand out there until Runge comes out to the mound. He's going to have at least a few words. Starting out fairly calm.
Well, it looked like Brian Runge had to beg Chris Dickerson to go to first base. So it's now 2-1. Here's Kepinger. The second base is loaded, walk. The Cubs have surrendered in the series. Called strike, and the Bronx cheer from the Cubs fans.
You know, this is neither the time nor the place to get into this discussion, Len, but you know, we talk about using instant replay to get home run calls right because they could possibly swing a game in one direction or another. Now, there was a case where a ball strike call cost the Cubs a run. And we've seen a lot of umpires just in the last week that call that low strike consistently. Brian Runge did not. Questech will tell you whether it was a strike or not.
One one pitch. Now 2-1. Good move by Gio. Said, I'll take care of it. You all right?
Oh, brother.
Broken bat, fly ball. This will be no problem for Soriano. He makes a catch, and the inning is over. And Jason Marquis not even going to look at Brian Runge. It's 2-1 Cubs.
The Arby's Rescue Brigade trains for the 99-cent barbecue deal.
Brigade? The RBQ is back, and it's available for just 99 cents. Arby's classic oven-roasted beef smothered in tangy barbecue sauce. And at just 99 cents, there's no better time to try one.
You growing a mustache, Tuffy?
Fun.
I like it.
Arby's is saving the world from ordinary fast food with a return of RBQ. Get yours for just 99 cents and try our delicious new orange cream swirl shake. It'll have you saying, I'm thinking Arby's.
Ode to the Subway $5 footlong. If you don't take a liking to the new Subway Everyday Value menu featuring ginormous subs slathered in awesome for a price just shy of insane, well, you are either born without taste buds or a fundamental understanding of economics. High five Abe Lincoln and choose one of 8 Yum Rockets for a 5 spot. $5 regular footlongs on the new Everyday Value menu. Only at Subway. Subway. Eat fresh.
Interception.
A commission.
Of the More Taste League. Bingo. You fellows have gotten your hands on some non-sanctioned light beer?
There was a big, shiny display.
The league only recognizes light beer with more taste and the scant 3.2 grams of carbs. That's the yin and the yang, the bot and the bing of light beer. Yes.
So which beers are league approved?
Beer, singular. Miller Lite.
Commish is wise.
Amen!
The official beer of the More Taste League. Miller Lite. Great taste, less filling.
Blackhawks, Cubs, and White Sox, Comcast Sportsnet. Cubs baseball is brought to you in part by Aflac. Ask about it at work and by the Toyota Tundra. Visit whytundra.com to find out why the Toyota Tundra is a great way to keep moving forward.
Can you imagine watching your first place Cubs from the very front row at Wrigley Field? Now you can. Visit Cubs.com and click on the CBOE. Front row seats auction to bid on tickets in the front row behind home plate and along the first base line. The auctions for the last two home series against the Brewers and Cardinals are going on now. Don't miss your chance to be part of the action and cheer your favorite Cubs from the very front row. Ice cream.
I knew that would get you.
So it's 2-1. after the bases loaded walk to Dickerson. The Soriano homered his last time up. Deep to left. And there's another one. And it's now 3-1. Second deck for Soriano. Well, he was 6-for-34 before the first home run. Looks like he's back. To Terrio.
I'll tell you, veteran hitters love to face a young pitcher who likes his fastball. You can't throw it hard enough for Alfonso Soriano not to turn it around. Now, if you put a little wrinkle in it, take a little off, move it around on the corners, it's a different story. But a guy that's just out there trying to blow his heater by every Cubs hitter, that could be exactly what the doctor ordered for the Cubs offense.
In a repeat of the third inning, right after the Soriano home run, Terrio with a single to center.
Our Belvedere going downtown, home run replay, knee high inside corner, no doubt about it. Golfs that ball into the second deck in left field.
Reds pitching coach Dick Pohl will head out to the mound. The pitch count for Cueto is at 60. He's thrown a ton of strikes, but two of them have ended up in the seats. 45 strikes, only 15 balls. Let's check in on the Coors Light freeze cam. Here's the first home run.
Inside part of the plate, middle of the thighs. Soriano just absolutely all over that one. The second home run was a similar pitch, but maybe down a few more inches, even a little bit lower. And he crushed the second one, too.
...26 home runs on the year for Soriano. Meanwhile, Terrio is at first, nobody out for Derek Lee. ...426 feet, the estimated distance on the second blast that found the second deck. Slider missed. 1-0.
You saw in our freeze cam, the first home run was inside part of the plate, middle of the thighs. This one inside corner and down around the knees. Alfonso Soriano has always been a real good low ball hitter and showing a quick bat against Cueto tonight.
Back-to-back sliders, both out of the strike zone. Tracking this ball, and he's going to get there on the warning track, sending Terrio back to first base.
Long run for Corey Patterson into that gap in right center field. Finally runs it down on the warning track. Terrio goes a little past halfway, ends up almost all the way to second base before that catch is made, and he has to retreat back to first base. You want to get out there in such a position where if the ball does drop, you possibly could score.
They have moved to the sixth in Milwaukee. It's still 1-0 Brewers. They got the lead in the bottom of the third on a Prince Fielder RBI double, scoring Ryan Braun. Hit foul by Aramis. And now they've gone to the last of the sixth. Ben Sheets has allowed two hits, no runs through six. Jake Peavy, one run on five hits through five. Ben Sheets tweaked his groin in his last start, but able to go tonight. The kick and the pitch. Smothered by Bacco. This game didn't mean anything in terms of playoff implications, but last night Oakland scored 8 runs in the 8th inning in an 11-2 win over the Orioles. They had one hit, a Rajay Davis grand slam, 6 walks, including 4 with the bases loaded and a hit batter. How about that? 8 runs on one hit.
Those are the kind of innings that are frustrating for a defense, because you're standing out there telling yourself and telling your pitcher, make him hit the ball. We'll make a play for you. We'll get out of this mess. And all you can do is watch pitch after pitch sail out of the strike zone, and guys walk down to first base, second base, third base, and score.
Terrio is safe. He got in, took off immediately. That ball didn't get too far away from Bacco. It's a wild pitch on Cueto.
Nice block by Paul Bacco, but it's tough to block and recover, pick that ball up and get it down there in time. Terrio just does get in underneath that quick tag by Brandon Phillips at second base.
Boy, that was really close. It's 2-2 on Aramis. Also up. This happened the other night, but I wanted to congratulate a former Cub, Scott McClain, who's now with the Giants. He hit his first major league home run at Colorado the other night in his 7,301st pro at bat, 19 years in the minor leagues. So we're happy for Scott. Had just 50 major league at bats as Ramirez strikes out. Kind of goes back to what we were talking about early on tonight with regard to your first major league hit. I'm sure Scott McClain felt a little bit that way with his first home run on a long road.
Well, congratulations to him. And some fans may remember a few days ago I sent out congratulations to the family of William Venable, who was called up by the Padres, got a triple in his first major league at bat, and he hit his first major league home run a few days ago. Max Venable, former outfielder with the Dodgers and the Reds and the Giants, Montreal Expos, was my roommate for a few years in the major leagues when we played together with the Giants.
One and one on Soto. Iowa with a chance to clinch its first round playoff series in the Pacific Coast League. Bobby Scales with a 3-run homer in the first inning. Barehanded play by Phillips. What a play as he gets Soto. That'll go 1-4-3 to get the out. Soriano, however, led off the inning with his second home run in as many at bats. 2 on the night. It's 3-1 Cubs.
Announcing Southwest Airlines regional sale. Right now, you can fly one of Southwest Airlines' daily flights from Chicago Midway to destinations such as Oakland, San Francisco, San Jose, Los Angeles, San Diego, Burbank, Ontario, and Sacramento. Fly Southwest Airlines from Chicago Midway to select cities in California for just $119 or $139 one way with a 21-day advance purchase. And with our low fares and no hidden fees, what you see is what you pay. Book your flight today at southwest.com.
You are now free to move about the country. Bank of America offers the opportunity to see Wrigley Field like you never have before. Take a 90-minute guided tour and check out the press box, locker room, dugouts, and much more. Tours are available on select dates and can be purchased by calling 1-800-THE-CUBS or by visiting cubs.com.
Burn After Reading is the new spy comedy critics are calling hilarious.
This is like raw intelligence.
And insanely funny.
Give me the CD
and I'll be the money.
It's a comedic masterpiece.
Oh, that's cool.
Burn After Reading, rated R, starts Friday.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone. You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on Buick Enclave with better fuel efficiency than Acura MDX. And right now, you can get a Buick Enclave starting at just $29,950. Offer ends September 30th.
Time now for a Buick Pontiac GMC Sports Update.
Hi, everyone. Gail Fisher with you. Join us for Lowe's Cubs postgame live after the game. Dan Plesac will join us to break it all down. And then later on Sports Night, they'll have all the college football action, including a record-setting day for Illinois' Juice Williams. That's tonight, but now back to Len and Bob in Cincinnati.
Thanks, Gail. It's 3-1. Cubs are trying to end a season-long six-game losing streak, and let's see how it goes with Jason Marquis and Brian Runge here in the bottom of the fifth.
Well, Jason needs to try to put that out of his mind and just continue to throw quality strikes. He's got real good movement on his sinker, has a real good straight change up tonight. Hopefully that won't upset him.
Phillips hustling out of the box, but it's picked up by Ramirez, and he throws him out by a couple of steps. So last time we saw the Reds, we noted that Brandon Phillips sometimes takes a little longer to get started because of his swing.
Now Phillips has really, really good speed, but sometimes it takes him a while to get unwound out of that batter's box. Ramirez comes in and actually pounded the glove before making the bare hand play. He was that sure that he had enough time. He got his body into a good position, turned sideways facing his target, and made a great barehanded scoop and throw.
Now he's really good at that barehanded play. So again, Iowa in game four of their best of five. They're at Oklahoma. They lead the series 2-1. Bobby Scales has had a huge series. His Botto's thrown out. He's grounded out all three times, 0 for 3. He drove in both their runs in the ball game last night in the 2-1 win. And a three-run homer in the first tonight. And in the single-A Florida State League, after the Daytona Cubs shut out Palm Beach 6-0 to win the first round series, they start the best of five championship series tonight. So there's no waiting around. They're at Fort Myers trailing 1-0 in the sixth inning. That's a best of five. Hung Wen Chen got the win in the clincher last night. 6 innings, 3 hits, no runs. Fouled off by Encarnacion, who's 2 for 2 tonight and 8 for 15 against Marquis in his career. Cubs basically counting on their fifth and sixth starters the rest of the weekend. Marquis tonight and Sean Marshall, who's filling in for Carlos Zambrano tomorrow. High in the air to left. Soriano took a look back, but he doesn't even have to get to the warning track. Nice shutdown inning. 1-2-3 go the Reds. We're through five, and now Marquis chatting with Runge. Cooler heads prevailing. 3-1 Cubs.
I've read a lot of books, wrote a few songs, looked at my life, where it's going, where it's gone. I've seen the world through a bus windshield, but nothing compares to the way that I see it when I sit in that old blue chair.
Hurry in to Toyota's National Clearance Event. Toyota is the most fuel-efficient full-line car company on the road today. And now's the perfect time to get amazing deals, like Camry, with an impressive 31 mpg highway rating. Or the 2009 Corolla, highway rated at 35 mpg. And while you're there, check out Yaris, with a 36 mpg highway rating. So hurry in and improve your MPG. The Toyota National Clearance Event is on now.
We're not going anywhere until our demands are met!
What are we gonna do now?
Hello. Jimmy John's?
Jimmy John's, America's sandwich delivery experts.
Wednesday, it's absolute arch madness as the Cubs light up the I-55 rivalry with a match against Albert Pujols and the St. Louis Cardinals, followed by Lowe's Cubs post-game live. Cubs Cards in HD, Wednesday at 7 on Comcast Sportsnet. Fans' best friend.
Get Chicago sports news nightly on Land Rover Sports Night. Coming up tonight after Cubs post-game live, a college football roundup. Plus, full recaps of tonight's Cubs and Sox games. Join Chuck and Kerry for Land Rover Sports Night tonight after Cubs postgame live, only on Comcast Sportsnet, fans' best friend. Cubs 3, Reds 1. We're in the sixth. Michael Hoffpower 0 for 2, but he does have an RBI. On a ground out in the fourth inning. He gets the start in right for the struggling Kosuke Fukudome. Hit foul off the end of the bat, 1-1. Well, it's Derek Lee's birthday, also Jeff Dillman's birthday, so happy birthday, Jeff. As Kepinger plays it on a hop, it throws out Hoffpower. Ran into a couple of huge Cub fans. They wanted to say hi to their parents. I want to say hi to Lenora and Martin Ramian. That's from your son, Mike. They're watching in Portage, Indiana. Also watching in Portage, John and Lori Maliziola. That's from your son, Johnny. Got a nice note from Sam. It's either Lappin or Lapin from Chicago Heights, Illinois, here watching the ball game tonight. Slider at 87, strike one on DeRosa. Looking for his first hit in the set, 0 for 5 to start it, 1 for 10 versus Cueto. Cruising along in Milwaukee. They're already in the bottom of the seventh. They basically started around the time we did. Still 1-0. Looks like guys are making quick outs against Sheets and Peavy.
That's been known to happen.
Low. Phillies and Mets will play a day-night doubleheader tomorrow. They were rained out at Shea. That's ball four, and that's the first walk issued by Cueto.
A good at bat by Mark DeRosa, was in an 0-2 hole right away. Worked his way back to the full count and draws the base on balls.
Oakland and Baltimore also were postponed. Greg Zaun with a game-ending grand slam in the 13th as the Blue Jays came back and beat the Rays 7-4. Tampa Bay had taken the lead in the top of that inning. Right-hander Jarrett Burton is warming up as Cueto's hit 80 pitches. That throw was in the dirt, dug out by Votto. Detroit got four in the eighth and beat the Twins 6-4 to help out the White Sox, who are trailing at home 5-3 in the top of the seventh, but their lead in the division is now 2 after the Twins lost. One and nothing on Reed Johnson. Back to the National League, the Cardinals just took the lead in the bottom of the sixth over the Marlins 4-3. Ugla with his 30th home run, Josh Willingham is 11th for the Marlins, and Albert Pujols hit number 31 for St. Louis. We'll see the Cardinals Tuesday night at Busch Stadium.
Cueto starting to show some signs of perhaps tiring a little bit out there on the mound, taking a lot more time between pitches, missing his spot by wider margins. Puts that one right on the outside corner for a called strike.
Sean Marshall and Aaron Harang tomorrow. And what the Cubs hope is the rubber game. Marshall will go into that outing 3-4 with a 4-0-3. Harang is 4-15 with a 5.24 earned run average. DeRosa runs and Johnson singles into right, and DeRosa's going to head to third base. They're at the corners with only one out.
Just an absolutely perfect hit and run. He got a good pitch to work with there, a fastball on the outside corner. Big hole on that right side of the infield. Reed Johnson took advantage. Get on that merry-go-round, first to third.
Dusty has made the call, the Heineken call to the pen. That's it for Johnny Cueto, marquee due up. He had Burton ready, looks like that's who's coming in. We'll be back.
Bank of America offers the opportunity to see Wrigley Field like you never have before. Take a 90-minute guided tour and check out the press box, locker room, dugouts, and much more. Tours are available on select dates and can be purchased by calling 1-800-THE-CUBS or by visiting cubs.com.
Here's something to celebrate. A new Applebee's neighborhood value. Endless favorites starting at $9.99. Choose from sweet and meaty riblets, panko-crusted shrimp, or golden delicious chicken tenders. Your choice, all you can eat, starting at $9.99. Be a shame not to have a cold beer with that. It's an all-you-can-eat dinner, but you gotta hurry. Endless riblets, shrimp, or chicken tenders, starting at $9.99. Only at Applebee's. It's a whole new neighborhood.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone. You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
And now we've extended the discount through September 30th. Use it to get the 2008 Chevy Silverado with better available V8 fuel economy than Tundra and F-150. That's right. Get this 08 Silverado half-ton for around $20,500 after all offers.
It's time to love your carpet. Call Luna for your second room free and a low price guarantee.
Look at you.
Call Luna today and get ready to love your carpet.
773-202. Luna.
Stay informed throughout the 2008 season with MLB.com Team Text Alerts. Customize your mobile alerts, including news, game summaries, scores, and more. Sign up now by texting Get Cubs to 65246 or visit MLB.com/mobile.
Right-hander Jarrett Burton was reinstated from the disabled list on Tuesday, and he pitched a scoreless inning that night against the Pirates. He went on the DL back on July 19th with a strained right lat, an injury suffered a couple of weeks earlier.
Speeding ticket, $300.
That's the one part of the story we didn't get. I assume that Matt Sinatra and Lou Piniella made it to Cincinnati without getting pulled over. They took their time. They drove the speed limit. Even though they got lost, they got here on time.
Yes, they did. And got to see a part of the state of Ohio they'd probably never seen before.
I think that's pretty obvious based on the path they took. They hadn't seen much of Ohio. So the corner men are in, Encarnacion on the grass. You have Votto holding on Johnson at first. Double play depth up the middle. Marquis at the plate. Tell you, if he can just do what he did against Cueto, he's going to get that fourth run home. Hit the ball into the outfield and well twice.
Could possibly be a pitch out here. Ooh, Burton threw it back over the plate. Yeah, you may have noticed Paul Bacco hung down the sign with the index finger and the little finger only. They call those horns. When you hang down the horns, that's usually an indication of some kind of a pickoff play. And after the horns, he just held the fist. The fist is a universal sign for a pitch out. This is the fake to third, throw to first. As soon as the pitcher sees that horn sign, that alerts him that you're not throwing a pitch to home plate. We're going to do some kind of a pickoff play. Usually horns one is a pickoff at first. The one we just saw where you wiggle the horns back and forth is the third to first. And then the horns with a fist is a pitch out.
I think I got all that. Hey, one note. I mentioned the A's and the O's were washed out. It was actually game one of a day-night doubleheader, so the day game was postponed. But they're playing the night game, and Oakland leads 5-0 in the bottom of the fifth. So how about that?
That's the blood type series. A and O.
Awkward looking swing by Marquis. He was just trying to stay alive, and he strikes out. But here comes Soriano, or Nissan drives of the game. Last two times up, he's hit home runs off the starter Johnny Cueto. See if he can do it a third straight time, this time against Jared Burton.
Now Burton, a guy that's a little more likely to go to a breaking pitch than Johnny Cueto. We talked about Cueto repeatedly liking that fastball, likes to challenge hitters with it. There's the slider on the outside corner right there. Soriano just got a piece of it.
I thought you were going to say that's the Ramones doubleheader. A-O, let's go.
Oh.
All right, we'll stop. I like yours better. Cubs 3, Reds 1. We're in the sixth. Cubs have gotten into the Reds bullpen. Jason Marquis has been strong tonight, allowing one run through five. The pitch. Nothing in two. With DeRosa at third, Johnson at first. Deep drive for Soriano, and there's number three. This time a three-run shot. It's 6-1. Man, is he hot. Well, he hit three home runs in a game in Atlanta last year. He's done it again on the road in Cincinnati. Five RBIs. You might get a curtain call.
The guys briefly gave him the silent treatment in the dugout down there.
Ryan Terrio high and deep, but this one will be caught by Dickerson on the warning track for the third out. I think they're going to pitch to him next time he comes up. A homer in the third, another in the fifth, one more here in the sixth. Well, the location nowhere near where Burton wanted it. Soriano made him pay, 6-1.
Recap on Comcast SportsNet. Hear what Lovie Smith has to say about the previous game and get a full preview of the upcoming weekend's matchup. Don't miss the Bears Recap every Monday at 5, only on Comcast SportsNet.
If you need to tow it, Quad City Spring has it. Quad City Spring is the area's suspension, spring, truck accessory, and towing experts. From goosenecks and fifth wheels to every kind of hitch imaginable, including Blue Ox base plates and tow bars. Strong as an ox. And Quad City Spring installs and services everything they sell. So tow it right. Get your ride to Quad City Spring. Quad City Spring, 34th Street at River Drive in Moline.
If it's got a motor.
We've bought two vehicles already from Clint Motorworks and can't begin to say how great each experience was. The selection and service is terrific.
Did you say service? That's where I come in.
That's right. We not only buy our vehicles here, we service them here as well. From our Kia sedan to our top-of-the-line BMW, we trust Clint Motor Works with all of our maintenance and repair. These guys actually let us know what's going on before we spend our money.
Don't get the runaround somewhere else. To be the next truly satisfied sales and service customer, we'll see you soon at Clinton Motor Works.
If it's got a motor.
With the Bulls, Blackhawks, Cubs, and White Sox, Comcast SportsNet.
Underway here in the bottom of the sixth, a 1-0 count on Jay Bruce. Here's a pitch by Marquis, fouled back. Third career three-homer game for Soriano. They've all come on the road. And he's had a three-homer game in each of the last three seasons with the Nationals on April 21st of 2006 in Atlanta. We mentioned June 8th of last year with the Cubs, and now he's done it on September 6th, 2008. Got a great ovation as he headed back to his position and left. That's foul. So it's picked up by Soto.
Well, you called it, Len. Burton missed his spot. Baca wants the pitch up and in. They threw it right down and in where he's hit the two previous home runs, and he knows what to do with that pitch. The third Belvedere going downtown replay for Fonzie in this game.
Well, that's what everybody hopes. And this has been a lot more fun tonight than the previous six games. The Cubs lost. Soriano with a long run. Terrio's going to get there first, however, make the catch in fair territory. One out. Now it's Corey Patterson. Pushed foul on the bunt attempt. Well, Ben Sheets threw 8 innings, a 3-hit shutout, 97 pitches. The Brewers are trying to add on in the bottom of the eighth. We'll see if Ned Yost sticks with his starter or if he goes to the bullpen in the ninth. Jake Peavy was really good, 7 innings, 1 run before he was taken out. But the big key for the Cubs is that they are leading 6-1. DeRosa will get it. Patterson's thrown out easily. Well, we saw quite a display of wiffle ball prowess, if you could call it that, before the ball game. Mascots from all over the world showed up for an exhibition game. Bacco thrown out. Shutdown inning for Marquis. He's really settled in. Pitch count not bad in the low 80s through six. It's 6-1.
Never before has the gecko been captured on film talking about RV insurance.
So, you guys travel a lot. You should check out Geico and get a free rate quote on RV insurance.
This is truly history in the making.
You can also get a rate quote on motorcycle insurance, ATV insurance, personal watercraft insurance.
Sounds good.
Excuse me, I'm up here.
Geico, saving you money on insurance for your car and the other stuff that moves you.
Show me what you tell me. Now we sipping cold belly and we up inside the telly. Roll you jellies on your belly and that spread up on your pillow. Bobby all inside your middle. This got me flipping like hotcakes on the griddle.
Hey Cubs fans, are you looking to get tickets to the hottest Cubs games this year? Visit Cubs.com and click on StubHub, the official fan-to-fan ticket marketplace of Cubs.com. Don't miss all the fun and excitement at the friendly confines with StubHub. There's always a ticket available to a Cubs game.
Hi, I'm Scott, and this is Jim, the voice of Lexus, to tell you about the IS.
Treat yourself to a ride in the IS, and you will be enveloped. With its sumptuous exterior, perforated leather, including a leather trim shift top, a leather shift tip top.
See your Chicago area and Northwest Indiana Lexus dealer.
Tomorrow night, get a complete recap of the Bears and Colts matchup on U.S. Cellular. Bears postgame live. Pat Boyle, former Bears Jim Miller, Jerry Azuma, and Dan Jiggets will break down all the action. Plus, William Jackson will bring you interviews with the players. U.S. Cellular Bears postgame live tomorrow night. Immediately after the game, only on Comcast Sportsnet, fans' best friend.
Hey, it's mascot mania here tonight. Yeah, that wiffle ball game you talked about earlier, Len, yeah, those costumes are not made for playing baseball.
The costumes?
Well,
I thought they were real. There's the bag of groceries mascot. The bats, I think.
Yeah, the Louisville Bats, yeah. I believe. That's the AAA ball club for the Cincinnati Reds. Swinging and running wasn't really the problem. It was picking up the ball once it was hit into play. Those costumes aren't made to look down toward the ground, and we saw a beheading during the course of the ball game too.
Big boy literally lost his head.
Lost his head.
Not good. D. Lee on his 33rd birthday is 1-for-3 with a double. Facing Jarrett Burton, and a soft liner will drop down in front of Dickerson for a base hit. Our other favorite was the blue blob.
That's as appropriate a description as we can think of, because that's basically what it was, just a furry blue blob. Yeah, there you see the blue blob dancing with Louie. And we're told that's one of the secondary mascots for Xavier University here in town.
Backhanded by Encarnacion. They'll get one. No throw by Phillips. Fielder's choice for Ramirez. When that game started, I thought it was the most ridiculous thing I'd ever seen in my entire life. And about 15 minutes later, I was transfixed. Who won, by the way?
I don't think they were keeping score.
Did the animals beat the inanimate objects?
I don't know. I'm just glad the vegetable man's not here anymore.
That guy,
that is a scary looking mascot.
That's going
right
to give
there.
Me nightmares.
Ooh. Boy, I'll see that in my sleep tonight.
I mean, most mascots, you want to be kid friendly, but I would think that most kids are going to run away from that one.
Just like they run away from vegetables, you know?
Are those real grapes? Not sure. Soto hits a high pop fly to right. And Jay Bruce will haul it in. Chris Bowden was slightly distracted when he did his pregame hit tonight. Don't touch the hair. He's like the Fonz. You can do whatever you want, just don't touch the hair. Look, I'm going on in 30 seconds. Give me a break. Gapper's put on a few pounds.
Yes, indeed.
The last time we saw Gapper. Hoffpower bounces it foul.
Mike has hit a couple balls hard in this game, including the ground ball to short back in the fourth inning that drove home Aramis Ramirez. Still hitless on the ball game.
Well, Ben Sheets is still in there in the ninth. It's still 1-0 Milwaukee. Line foul. Padres have a man on with nobody out. Jody Garrett at first base. Pinch running. After Luis Rodriguez singled. It was an infield hit. Mentioned Tampa Bay lost. The Red Sox on the comeback trail. They were down 7-1 at Texas, but they've scored three in the third, so it's now 7-4. That game being played in Arlington. If the Red Sox come all the way back, they'll draw to within a game and a half of first in the American League East. They've won four straight. Outside. 1-2. This will be it for Burton. His spot due to lead off the bottom of the inning. Dusty had Andy Phillips, a right-handed hitter, in the on-deck circle when Bacco grounded out back in the sixth. Votto plays behind Ramirez at first. The pitch, another one is wide. It's 3-2. So now Aramis will get a head start with two outs. Damaging blow for the Astros as they lost last night. ending their long winning streak. They're scoreless in the fifth at Colorado. Another one pulled foul by Hoffpower as he'll get a new bat. So he's taking the pitches off the outside corner, and the ones that are in, he's out in front. The Astros are in fourth in the wild card. They're seven back of Milwaukee. Again, the Phillies were rained out at New York. They're two back in their division and four out in the wild card. The Cardinals six games back and in third in the wild card, and they still lead 4-3 in the eighth at home against Florida. Marlins won an extras last night in St. Louis. Ball four, good at bat. Two on for DeRosa.
Mark DeRosa 0 for 2 in the game. He did draw a walk and scored a run back in the sixth inning. That was the at bat he was behind 0 and 2 against Johnny Cueto and came back to draw the base on balls.
Missed on a slider.
That first pitch breaking ball, it's so important that the pitcher throw it in the strike zone. I don't recall a hitter in my playing days or since where you talked about him in the advance meeting and they said he's a first ball breaking ball hitter. Now some guys will hit a first ball breaking ball on occasion, but the overwhelming majority of major league players are first ball fastball hitters. So if you can throw that breaking ball.
Patterson going back. This ball's very deep. He's going to get to the wall. Another three-run homer for the Cubs. This time it's DeRosa, and it's 9-1. That's his 20th homer of the season. RBIs 81, 82, and 83.
DeRosa now 3 for 3 lifetime against Burton with two singles and a three-run homer.
Both the three-run blasts have come with two outs. Soriano's in the sixth, DeRosa's in the seventh. Well, the Reds won 10-2 last night, and the Cubs lead 9-1 tonight. Broken bat grounder, Johnson hustling, but Kepinger's going to throw him out. As we get up and stretch here in Cincinnati, the Cubs offense breaking out of its recent malaise. DeRosa with a three-run homer, four blasts tonight. It's 9-1.
Coors Light on tap. Because if you want an ice-cold draft, look no further than ice-cold frost-brewed Coors Light. It's aged cold, filtered cold, and stored cold. Brought to your bar and poured cold. So ask for a draft beer with a taste as cold as the Rockies, because refreshment isn't everything. It's the only thing. Frostbrewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer.
Toyota Moving Forward is more than just a slogan. It's the way it is. Hello, I'm Bruce Dickstein of David Bruce Toyota. Toyota's having a remarkable year. The reason? Toyota builds superior vehicles. Vehicles like this.
Lease an 09 Toyota Camry LE for $209 per month for 36 months or buy for $20,158.
David Bruce Toyota delivers a buying experience and an atmosphere based on trust and respect that keeps our customers coming back.
Good morning, Mike.
Morning, Bill.
Morning.
Morning.
I think I might need some better brakes.
You need our Midas Secure Stop brake service.
Really?
Yeah. Exceptional stopping power combined with the security of a 55-point brake inspection.
And the pads are lifetime guaranteed.
So next time this one.
That's why we call it Secure Stop.
Trust the Midas touch.
Chicago Tribune Live, presented by your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. Weeknights at 5:30 on Comcast Sportsnet. Fans' best friend.
Visit the legendary Harry Carey's Italian Steakhouse at Harry Carey's Tavern in Wrigleyville, where Ernie Banks and Ryan Sandberg hang their hats. Call 773-HOLY-COW or visit harrycareys.com today. Well, a comfortable 9-1 advantage for Jason Marquis. He's gotten past his little tiff with the home plate umpire, Brian Runge. Really has settled in nicely. Well, Will Venable took Ben Sheets to a full count with runners at first and third and two outs, but Sheets got him. Ball was put in play and it was an out. Don't know exactly how they got him, but Milwaukee hangs on 1-0. So they beat the Padres. It was a ground out, 4-3 to end it. So a complete game shutout for Sheets. Five hits. 120 pitches, 82 for strikes.
Wow. Locked in.
He beat Jake Peavy. Andy Phillips, a pinch hitter, skying into center. One out.
Marquis spot due to lead off the top half of the eighth inning. He's sitting at 87 pitches right now. Still a very manageable pitch count. We'll see what Lou chooses to do. Nobody warming in the Cubs bullpen right now, so you would have to assume at this point that he'll take his at bat in the eighth.
Fouled back to the top of the screen by Dickerson. Who's playing left? Their lone run came as a result of a bases loaded walk in the fourth. Dickerson stood at home plate. He didn't even go to first until he was reminded by Brian Runge, the home plate umpire, that it was ball four.
Another good changeup from Jason Marquis. Boy, he's had two pitches working extremely well tonight. His slider has kind of been hit or miss. He's thrown some good ones. He's missed badly with others. He's had that good late breaking sinker, real good straight changeup tonight. Change up here.
Swing and a miss, strike three. It's only a second strikeout, but that's okay. He's been able to keep that pitch count down.
Where the arm action, everything tells the hitter it's a fastball, and that thing floats up there about 10 to 12 miles an hour slower than the fastball. Dickerson couldn't hold up.
A win tonight would be his 10th. He would be the fourth Cubs pitcher to get to double digits this season. The Cubs have 3 13 game winners. Ted Lilly with 13. Big Z has 13. Ryan Dempster with 15. And it would be the fifth consecutive 10 win campaign for Marquis. Kepinger with a rainbow out into right center. Johnson catches and they go down in order. That's 10 straight retired by Marquis since the bases loaded walk in the fourth. 9-1 to the eighth.
Thank you. How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Nine, please. don't like stopping? Fly Southwest Airlines from Chicago Midway to Denver for just $89 one way. And with our low fares and no hidden fees, what you see is what you pay. So book now at southwest.com.
You are now free to move about the country.
With the refreshingly cool taste of the Bacardi Mojito.
We've created a Chicago destination that's truly unprecedented. A celebration for the senses, where the night comes alive and stars electrify your soul. The all-new Horseshoe Casino, where entertainment knows no bounds. Now open.
Time for the Sharp Aquas game-changing play. Remember that pitch? Marquis was very upset he didn't get it. But right after that, he got Kepinger to get out of the inning. So they got only one, and again, he hasn't given up a base runner since. He's pretty animated.
Well, he was plugged into this ball game tonight from the very start. I think he recognized that he had really good stuff tonight and thought he had made a good pitch on that 3-0 and indicated such to the home plate umpire Brian Runge.
By the way, during the break they announced that Mike Fontenot had come into play second. And DeRosa had gone over to third, so Ramirez out. I guess everybody missed it, including us. Well, Jason worked pretty quickly in that inning. Soriano on deck, bidding to become the first Cub ever to hit four homers in a game. That's deep to right for Jason Marquis. That is his fourth career home run, his first of the season, and it's 10-1. We talked about his first two at bats. They were excellent at bats against Johnny Cueto. He struck out in the sixth, but takes Gary Majeski deep here in the eighth. First homer since May 19th of last year. Here's Soriano. Can't show you the replay because Soriano might hit another one. Outside on a slider. 10-1 Cubs.
And most of the fans here at Great American Ballpark on their feet for Soriano, trying to will the fourth home run for the Cubs left fielder.
Five home runs tonight for the Cubs. Just a lousy old single. It's his fourth hit tonight. Three homers and a single.
Well, you heard Lou say before the ball game, if you produce, you play. And apparently Jason Marquis wants to play. Our Belvedere going downtown, home run replay. The third ball he's hit right on the button tonight. This one gets up and out to right field. I still got it, honey.
For Soriano, 13 total bases tonight. Three homers and a single. Tapper hit by Terrio. Picked up on the bare hand. Kepinger will sling it across and get the out.
Well, that shot of Soriano kind of laughing as he was over there at first base. Joey Votto standing right behind him had a three-homer game against the Cubs earlier this year in this ballpark. A couple of sluggers comparing notes down there.
Third hit. He's going to knock in Soriano to make it 11-1.
This ball is absolutely scalded down that third baseline. Top spin grounder shoots past Encarnacion. If you want to play, you got to produce. Apparently, a lot of the Cubs hitters took it to heart tonight.
Fontenot with his first at bat. He's playing second. With DeRosa moving to third and Ramirez out. The Soriano has tied his career best with four runs in a ball game. The Cubs have scored in every inning since the third. Well, this is more like it. After the Cubs got pummeled last night, back to their huge offensive ways tonight. Jason Marquis has been outstanding.
Usually when you see this kind of an output from the Cubs offensively, there are a lot more base on balls involved. Only two walks in the game for the Cubs offense, but when you're pounding the ball the way they've been in this game tonight, that's all right.
You can't argue with the results.
See some stirring around down there in that third base dugout. Lou may possibly be pulling some of the starters in this game. Get some playing time for some of the guys on the bench. Much prefer to do it this way than the way he had to do it last night in a losing cause. Cleared the bench in the sixth inning, got all the extra men in there, but tonight ahead by 10 runs in the eighth inning, this is the way you prefer to do it.
So Coy Hill will bat and stay in and catch for Soto. Coy with two hits last night. A lot of pressure on him right now. He's batting 1,000.
His double in the ball game last night came against starter Bronson Arroyo. Came to the gap in left center field as a left-handed hitter. See if he could do it again.
A career high in home runs at Triple A Iowa, 17. Made his major league debut with the Dodgers in 03, played with the Diamondbacks in 04 and 05, and the Cubs last year, and now again here in 2008.
If I remember correctly, I'll have to ask Coy tomorrow. When he was with the Cubs before, he wore sleeves every game. It was notable because even on the hottest, most humid days, he had long sleeves on underneath his uniform. A little different look for him this year. I have to ask him about that.
let his hair grow out a little bit too. Majeski's given up two runs here in the eighth. The starter Cueto is charged with five. Jarrett Burton in an inning and two thirds surrendered four. Kick and the pitch in on the hands, fouled back. Been a struggle for Majeski lately. Came in with a 12.38 earned run average over his last 10 appearances. His ERA was 3.45 before this stretch. It's in the mid fives now. A long look by Majeski. And the 1-2 pitch, a swing and a miss, strike three, two outs. Well, as the Cubs were losing, the Brewers went on a losing streak. Brewers won late last night. Cubs coming back, winning tonight. Milwaukee won as well. Again, the standings don't change as every day it goes by. That's good for the Cubs. Start crossing off these games. 20 left after tonight. The Brewers can hang their hat on the fact that they play the Cubs six more times. And I suppose it's possible you could go into the final weekend of the season in Milwaukee with both teams having clinched a playoff spot, and maybe the division title is on the line, but both teams will be in. It'll be a souvenir, and Micah will have to get another bat. Boy, if that happened, then we could play the what-if game all night. The Cubs hope to clinch well before that, but if you go in knowing that both teams are in, the incentive to win it would be you get home field advantage probably throughout the NL playoffs. But that would be interesting.
And just looking at the schedule, you mentioned those six games between the Cubs and the Brewers in the last 2 weeks of the season, and depending on off days and how Ned Yost chooses to line up his rotation, you have to believe we're going to get Sabathia twice and Ben Sheets twice.
You would think so. Bruce will make the catch. Marquis led off the inning with the Cubs' fifth homer of the night. His fourth career blast. Derek Lee with an RBI double. It's now 11-1.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone.
You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Now through September 30th, you pay what we pay on every 2008 Cadillac model. Like the award-winning CTS, with better available highway gas mileage than the Lexus GS Hybrid. GM employee pricing for everyone. Visit your local Cadillac dealer.
What's this?
That's called League Violation Light.
Kamish?
Of the More Taste League, I am shocked. This light beer with less taste has introduced a very uncool situ into this so-called cooler. Yeah, it's pretty funny, depriving people of Miller Lite.
No.
Wrong, but it's funny faux pas, not funny ha-ha. Well,
can I cut a deal?
I've convened with myself, and the citation is commuted. Let this guy's whistle.
The official beer of the More Taste League. Miller Lite, great taste, less filling.
Bowlmore Lanes wants you to come out and bowl at our new state-of-the-art synthetic Brunswick Pro Lanes. This fall, whip up some fun at Bowlmore Lanes. We offer a full-service snack bar, drink specials, and bowling specials throughout the week, as well as glow bowling on Friday and Saturday nights. And now is a great time to sign up for our fall leagues. With leagues running 7 days and nights a week, we can find one to fit your schedule. Bowmore, serving up fun for over 65 years. Bowmore Lanes, 29th and Brady in Davenport.
From the Comcast Sportsnet Studios, it's a Cadillac Sports Update.
Hi, everyone. Gail Fisher with you. Lowe's Cubs postgame live is on after the game. Then Sports Night has a one-on-one interview with Lovie Smith. The Bears are huge underdogs opening the season in Indy tomorrow night. Plus, we'll have highlights of all the big football games today. That's a little bit later, but now more Cubs baseball with Len and Bob.
Thanks. Having fun on a Saturday night in Cincinnati. It's 11-1, and Jason Marquis is still working in the bottom of the eighth. An intriguing change. Ronnie Cedeno is playing left. Not a bad idea. Coy Hill stays in to catch. So Soriano's done after a three-homer night. Four hits, four runs. Rolled foul by Phillips. So let's see. Cedeno has never played left in the majors. His previous stint in the outfield totaled one inning in center earlier this year. That's been it. And unlike September, when you have the expanded roster, you don't in the playoffs. So if you get in a pinch, you might need Ronnie to go out and play the outfield. Neil Kotz and Jeff Samardzija up in the Cubs bullpen as Marquis is nearing 100 pitches. Two pitch, ball four. That's the fifth walk tonight for Marquis. Pledge your allegiance to the Cubs by becoming a member of the Cubs Club, the official online fan club for the Chicago Cubs. Cubs Club members will get benefits unavailable to other fans, including your very own 2008 membership card, MLB.com's game day audio for the 2008 regular season, and much more. To join today, visit Cubs.com, where baseball is always on. One and one on Joey Votto. Well, the Cubs have scored 10, and you've scored 10. Just send an email with your name and address to sackof10 at ComcastSportsnet.com immediately after the game, and you could be one of 100 lucky winners to win a free White Castle sack of 10. Two balls, two strikes. It's a final in St. Louis. The Cardinals beat the Marlins 5-3. Houston's leading at Colorado 2-0. They're in the top of the seventh. Milwaukee won tonight, 1-0 at home against the Padres. The Dodgers have jumped into first in the West with a 7-2 victory over Arizona. So the current standings, but the Cubs leading by 10, going after their 86th win. That's a foul ball.
Inland, just looking at Jason Marquis game by game in the second half of the season, and much has been made that Jason struggles in the second half, usually after a very strong first half. This year has been a little different for him. He's 3-3 in all three of his losses. He had quality starts, gave his team a chance to win a ball game. In the two no decisions that he's had since the All-Star break, he wasn't very good, but he could very easily be 5-1 or 6-0 with a couple of no decisions in the second half of the season. He's thrown the ball that well since the break. Mentioned his last time out against the Astros, a 3-0 loss. He went 6 innings, gave up only 5 hits, 2 runs, struck out 8 batters, but came away with a loss because his team couldn't score a run.
Way up in the air for Johnson. And that's probably it. Lou heading out. He has Kotz and Samardzija in the bullpen.
They've got back-to-back-to-back lefties after Edwin Encarnacion.
Big hand for Marquis, did it all tonight, hit a home run at the plate, and he exits with an 11-1 lead. Heineken call to the pen. We'll be back.
Quiet on the set, pick 73.
Hello out there in TV land.
Save your boss laughter.
Very popular. Whoa, get your foot off the fogger. Okay, here we go with another ho-ho.
There's only one, Bob Roman.
We've created a Chicago destination that's truly unprecedented. A celebration for the senses, where the night comes alive and stars electrify your soul. The all-new Horseshoe Casino, where entertainment knows no bounds. Now open.
Now more than ever, you want to get the most for your money. Look no further than the rugged V6 2008 Kia Sportage. Fuel efficient, 5-star safety rated, backed by an industry-leading warranty, and it's priced about $6,000 less than a Toyota RAV4 Limited. Or to put it another way, a whole year's worth of groceries less. The 2008 Kia Sportage. It's money well saved. Hurry in and get up to $3,000 cash back on the 2008 Kia Sportage.
Handshakes and hugs in the dugout as Marquis and Soto work so well together tonight. So Jason will just put his feet up and watch the rest of it. As Jeff Samardzija takes over, you think he watched some college football this afternoon?
I think he probably did. Well, you know, you saw that shot of Giovanni Soto and Jason Marquis. That's such an important relationship, your starting catcher and your starting pitcher on a given night, to be able to immediately recognize what he has working, what's not working, how are we going to attack these hitters. And that's why I'm a firm believer in a team having a starting catcher, a guy that catches the bulk of the games, because he can tell from start to start with each individual pitcher what they have working on a given night.
Pulled foul by Encarnacion.
Now, I think it was pretty easy for Gio to recognize early on tonight that Jason had his good sinking fastball and a real good changeup, and they went to that changeup perfectly tonight.
Encarnacion just got hit. It was not a fastball. Still didn't feel good. So two on for the Reds. One of their athletic trainers will come out, Dusty Baker as well, to check on his third baseman.
Oh, right on the back of the left elbow. If you've ever whacked your crazy bone before, imagine doing it with 90 mile an hour pitch.
So Encarnacion is going to stay in for the time being.
They're looking for a pinch runner.
Yeah, I think it might be Holbert Cabrera.
Really no point in staying in this ball game at this point.
Walking a hit batter here in the inning. One out, the Cubs lead by 10. Knee-high strike on a heater from Samardzija to Jay Bruce. Brandon Phillips at second, Cabrera's at first. Two and one.
And Len, we mentioned that Kotz was warming up along with Jeff Samardzija in the bullpen. And after Jay Bruce, you've got Corey Patterson and Paul Bacco, three left-handed hitters lined up in a row here. But Jeff Samardzija has done a nice job against the lefties this year. He's held them to a 118 batting average.
Two and two the count. Here's a pitch. He's run it full. The payoff delivery outside. He's loaded the bases. Larry Rothschild heading out.
It looked like Samardzija really tried to overthrow that last pitch, dropped his arm angle, got underneath the pitch. It sailed up and away from the left-handed hitting Jay Bruce. Be a suggestion for a quick mechanical adjustment and go right back after Corey Patterson right here, looking for a ground ball.
Still no hits in the inning. Two walks and a hit batsman, and they have them loaded. Here we go. Strike one on a fastball.
First pitch fastball for a called strike, then an attempt at a backdoor slider that Patterson fouled off. And we know from past experience, you can go a couple of different directions now. You can elevate a fastball on Corey. You can throw him that splitter down in the dirt, try to get him to chase. Looks like they want something up, fastball up.
Check swing foul.
Now you notice Coy Hill didn't even give a sign. No fingers as far as fastball, breaking ball, splitter. He just signaled up. And the only pitch that Jeff Samardzija would throw up is a fastball.
He would throw up a fastball?
Yeah, you could. Depends on how many fastballs you eat.
Bouncer to Derek Lee, and it kicks away from him, and everybody's safe, and they'll get two runs. Phillips and Cabrera score on an error by Derek. And it's 11-3.
Derek frustrated with himself, tried to come in and smother that ball on the short hop. Just kind of climbed up his wrist, hit him on the heel of the glove, popped up in the air, and heads up base running by Holbert Cabrera at second base to realize that ball had gotten away from Derek into foul territory, and he came on home to score.
So they have scored twice without the benefit of a hit. Gives this one a long ride. Johnson's back on it. It's going to hit the warning track, and the Reds are going to get two more, and it's now 11-5. Bacco with a two-run double.
Fastball down over the middle of the plate. Thought not that bad of a pitch. Bacco just with a nice piece of hitting went down and dug it out and drove it to the gap in right center.
Switch hitting rookie Wilkin Castillo's in the on deck circle. Not sure if he's going to bat, but Neil Kotz, the left-hander's coming in. Heineken called to the pen. It's now 11-5 Cubs. We'll be back.
Johns?
Who are Jimmy Johns?
Jimmy Johns, America's sandwich delivery experts.
We've come to this island, and you'll never believe what we found. The internet. Seems it can't hide here either. Simply insert the AT&T laptop connect card. You're connected at up to 3G speeds. Email business proposals. Access your customer database. All on the go. I'm Bill Curtis. And I've just found the internet.
The internet can't hide anymore. Switch to the network with the best coverage and get the AT&T Laptop Connect card for free.
In celebration of our 100th anniversary,
we're sharing our GM employee discount
with everyone.
You pay what we pay.
Not a cent more.
The GM employee discount.
For everyone.
Just announced, the employee discount for everyone is now extended on Buick Enclave with better fuel efficiency than Acura MDX. And right now, you can get a Buick Enclave starting at just $29,950. Offer ends September 30th.
Here's left-hander Neil Kotz facing Wilkin Castillo, switch hitter, pinch hitting for Majeski, and he'll be forced to bat right-handed. Well, not forced, but that's what he'll do.
Only five at-bats on the season for Castillo. Two from the right side of the plate where he's 1-for-2. Three as a left-handed hitter where he's 1-for-3. Part of that Adam Dunn deal with the Arizona Diamondbacks.
Brought up from AAA Louisville on Sunday, made his debut Tuesday, and got his first hit Wednesday. Way high, ball one. Four in here in the eighth. Reds have been helped by an error by Derek Lee. Paul Bacco just knocked in two with a double, first hit of the inning. Castillo sounds like he can play anywhere. Can catch, play the infield, play the outfield. That pretty much covers it. I don't know if he can pitch, but he does just about everything else.
Dusty Baker described him as an Eli Marrero type. Eli Marrero had a very good career playing multiple positions, most notably for the St. Louis Cardinals.
Two and two. Well, it's a final, so Daytona wins game one of the best of five in the Florida State League Championship Series. Good start for Jody Davis and the Daytona Cubs. Iowa trails at Oklahoma 6-5 in the bottom of the fourth. It's game four of that series. Hoffpower drifts back. Now he gets set. Bacco tags from second. He's on his way to third. And he'll slide in safely. Two outs in the inning. Maybe the last chance for Dickerson to extend his hitting streak to 9. I didn't quite get all of that. Did you get the scoring change?
Yeah, I think on the Corey Patterson ball that Derek Lee made the error at first base, they've given him one RBI for the first run that scored in that situation, and the second one that scored was considered unearned.
Got it. Two and one on Dickerson. Now 2-2. Good slider from Cotts. Reds have scored four in the eight to make it 11-5 Cubs. 2-2 pitch is hit foul. Bacco's at third. The next pitch, ground ball near Fontenot, gobbles it up, and the inning is over. They get four, but we'll head to the ninth, and the Cubs lead by 6.
We've come to this bayou because we found something extraordinary. The internet. It seems it can't hide here either.
Simply insert the AT&T Laptop Connect card and you're connected at up to 3G speeds.
Download presentations. Even track your company's inventory. All on the go. I'm Bill Curtis. And I just found the internet.
The internet can't hide anymore. Switch to the network with the best coverage and get the AT&T Laptop Connect card for free.
Show me what you tell me. Now we sipping cold Belvy and we up inside the telly. Well, you jellies on your belly and that's right up on your pillow. Bobby all inside your middle. This got me flipping like hotcakes on the griddle.
When a major hospital wanted to add on to their benefits package at no direct cost to the company, their very first word was...
Aflac! Aflac!
Find out more at aflacforbusiness.com.
Create curb appeal with Mastermark Lawn Edging and Menards. Choose from a 20-foot roll of yard and garden edging or a 4-foot section of poundable edging that can be easily installed with no trenching. Great for straight or curved designs, only $2.82 each. Ensure a beautiful lawn in the spring by preparing in the fall with Turf Champ Grass Seed. It's specially formulated for fall planting. Just $5.99 for a 5-pound bag.
Save big money at Menards.
After the game, stick around for Lowe's Cubs postgame live. Get highlights of all the action and analysis from Dan Plesac. Don't miss Lowe's Cubs postgame live immediately following the game right here on Comcast Sportsnet, fans' best friend. Well, I know they love me. It said Len and I'm assuming it's Bob.
Lennon. D-Ro. Mike Lincoln takes over for the Reds. 56th ball game of the season for him.
And Holbert Cabrera stays in to play third after running for Encarnacion and got hit by a pitch. There it is. You are loved.
I feel loved.
See, they haven't lost that loving feeling.
Ooh. We've come full circle with the Righteous Brothers.
One and oh on DeRosa. He had a 3-run home run his last time up. Breaking ball strike. We've talked about Lincoln before. Did not play professionally from 05 to 07. Was recovering from Tommy John surgery.
You can get a good fastball that'll reach the low 90s. Big over the top breaking ball. Did the sinker right there at 91. Got D-Row just to get a piece of it.
Works from the windup, and it's driven left center, but caught by Dickerson. Johnson digs in. Darrell Ward's going to bat next. So it looks like we're going to see Carlos Marmol in the bottom of the ninth. After Ward bats for Cots. That caught the edge.
It's been 4 days for Carlos Marmol since he last pitched against the Houston Astros back at Wrigley. Two innings of hitless shutout baseball. It's time to get him back out on that bump.
A blooper, and it'll drop as Johnson busted his bat. Unfortunately, because of the configuration of this ballpark, we can't shoot the bullpens, can't show the guys warming up. We can tell you who's out there. That's about all we see.
Yeah, if you're really alert and you watch the dugout, when you see Larry go to the phone, if you get your binoculars on the bullpen, you can see who jumps up and takes off their jacket. That's about the easiest way to figure out who's warming up.
Ward in the air to left. Dickerson with the grab, two outs. And it brings up, strange to say, left fielder Ronnie Cedeno. You missed it earlier. Alfonso Soriano with a three homer night, scored four runs, knocked in five. He came in six for his last 33. And we said last night, three strikeouts, two walks, he didn't put a ball in play. And rolled in the left. Well, he put a few in play tonight. Actually, of the five at bats, only two ended up in the ballpark. The other three were out of the ballpark.
He doesn't play well with others. I'm just curious if Lou and Fonzie would have known that his spot would roll around here again in the ninth inning. I wonder if he would have stayed in the ballgame and taken a shot at that fourth home run. I mean, he singled in the eighth inning, and you kind of figured, well, that's his last at bat of the game. Let's get him out of there. Let Ronnie Cedeno get a little bit of time out there in left field just to acclimate him to that position. But now the spot comes up here in the ninth, and Ronnie comes through with a base hit.
Terrio looking for a strong finish to the season. His average has gone up 1 point tonight from 308 to 309. And I know what Ryan will tell you if you ask. I'm not even going to ask because it's just pointless. He wants to finish in the 300s. He'll tell you all that matters is that we win this division and get to the playoffs. But he's worked way too hard, and he's been in the 300s all season, to let it slip away here in the final 3 weeks.
Well, his approach at the plate is such that I think he's going to hang on easily and hit over 300 this season. Certainly I hope so. And he's not a guy that gets fooled by off-speed pitches very often. He hits the ball to the opposite field a lot. With good eye for the strike zone, he can foul off the borderline pitcher's pitches to stay alive in an at-bat. And all those things usually add up to base hits or base on balls, which will keep your average right where you want it.
Runners moving on to 3-2, and they are loaded up for Derek Lee.
Been a good birthday for Derek Lee, 3 for 5 with a couple of doubles.
Well, you know he's not happy about the error he made, but you're right, he's had an excellent night at the plate. Two. base hit in the left. His fourth of the night. The Cubs are going to get two to make it 13-5. I think he's more than made up for that error with that swing right there.
He's hit some balls right on the button tonight. Well, that's the kind of pitch that will make a pitching coach get gray hairs right there. Lincoln painted the outside corner twice to go to 0-2 and then threw a fastball right down the middle of the plate for Derek Lee to whack into left field.
Mike Fontenot, the base hit. Terrio's going to come in. 14-5.
Mike Fontenot just served that ball out into left center field, just kind of flipped it over the head of the shortstop, Jeff Kepinger. Nice controlled swing, watching that ball all the way to contact, and just does get it over the red shortstop.
Coy Hill is the eighth Cub to bat in the ninth. It's a third inning in which they've scored at least or exactly three runs. Cubs have scored in seven consecutive innings. Well, a lot of the RBI is coming with two outs. Five hits with runners in scoring position and 14 at bats.
Cubs have drawn four base on balls in this game. Three of those runners came around to score.
Another 3-2 count, runners at first and second. The Cubs lead by 9. Called strike 3 to end the inning. Three outs to go as the Cubs are in great shape to snap their 6-game losing streak. It's 14-5.
Not too close. What do you think? I got that insurance?
What insurance is that, Yogi?
Aflac. The one you really need to have. If you don't have it, that's why you need it.
Need what?
Aflac. Well, if you get hurt and miss work, it won't hurt to miss work.
Uh-huh.
And they give you cash, which is just as good as money.
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Here's something to celebrate. A new Applebee's neighborhood value. Endless favorites starting at $9.99. Choose from sweet and meaty riblets, panko crusted shrimp, or golden delicious chicken tenders. Your choice, all you can eat, starting at $9.99. Be ashamed not to have a cold beer with that. It's an all you can eat dinner, but you gotta hurry. Endless riblets, shrimp, or chicken tenders, starting at $9.99. Only at Applebee's. It's a whole new neighborhood.
Thank you.
Now the Feltco Cubs upcoming schedule will be back on Comcast Sportsnet Wednesday night from St. Louis. It starts a string four straight here on Comcast Sportsnet. On to St. Louis and then Houston. It'll be Michael Wirtz instead of Carlos Marmol with the Cubs leading by nine. Yeah, they're ready to sing and hang the W flag. Now, many have headed for the exits. They already announced before today that this was a sellout. I don't think there's any question there were more Cubs fans here tonight than Reds fans. Wirtz against Kepinger as we start the last of the ninth. Ball one on a fastball. The lead will remain at four in the division. Cubs will add a half game to their lead on clinching a playoff spot. As they would be essentially 8.5 better than the Philadelphia Phillies, who are in second in the wild card. With an opposite field single. That game in Milwaukee tonight, Bob, took 2 hours and 7 minutes to complete. It was 1-0. We're still going. We're beyond 3 hours. Very different feel in this one. 14-5. A lot of runs, a lot of hits.
Well, as good as Johnny Cueto's stuff is, he didn't miss many bats tonight. The Cubs hit him hard. They banged him around pretty good in his 5 1/3, and the onslaught has just continued against every Reds reliever that's marched into this ball game.
The kick and the 0-1 to Phillips. He'll ask down at first base, and Scott Barry said he held.
It really looks like Michael Wirtz has tightened up that slider, and his stint down at AAA Iowa this year, certainly something he wasn't looking forward to and didn't anticipate, but he took made good use of his time down there at the AAA level. Looks like he's tightened up that slider, late break, more downward action than sideways.
Well, Phillips just able to get his hands out of the way. There's a hot potato coming in at 91 miles an hour. DeRosa can't get it. First two have reached.
Notice the location of the pitch. Coy Hill wanted it down and away. It strayed back over the inner part of the plate. Phillips found that hole in the left side.
Hill out to chat with Wirtz. I mean, you have a 9-run lead here, and the one thing you'd like to avoid is having to use somebody else in this ninth inning.
I think that's what Lou's thinking about right now, pacing around down there in that third base dugout. He doesn't want to have to bring another pitcher into this ball game. He'd like to think Michael Wirtz could get three quick outs here and send the team on home.
swing and a miss at a slider. Boy, Votto did Michael a huge favor. Ahead in the count, and he chased a pitch in the dirt. And Carlos Marmol, who won't need long to get ready, is back up.
You know, Lou's comments before the ball game about the guys that produce are the guys that are going to play. I think that carries over to the pitching staff as well. I'm sure he was referring to the offense, but that's been Lou's attitude pretty much since the day he took this job here in Chicago. If you get the job done, you earn playing time.
Lou walking out with three key runs in the top of this inning. And he is not happy. He would have gone, I think, with Marmol had the Cubs not gotten the three in the top of the ninth. But that'll be it for Michael Wirtz. Heineken called to the pen. And Marmol try to close him out. Cubs lead by nine, but the Reds have the bases loaded with no outs.
Announcing Southwest Airlines regional sale. Right now you can fly one of Southwest Airlines daily flights from Chicago Midway to destinations such as Oakland, San Francisco, San Jose, Los Angeles, San Diego, Burbank, Ontario, and Sacramento. Fly Southwest Airlines from Chicago Midway to select cities in California for just $119 or $139 one way with a 21-day advance purchase. And with our low fares and no hidden fees, what you see is what you pay. Book your flight today at southwest.com.
Are now free to move about the country.
I can't believe I'm beating Billie Jean King.
You're not beating me. In fact, you haven't even got a serve in.
Okay. You might want to take a gander at the scoreboard. Whoa. What's with the Geico sign, Billie Jean?
They're sponsoring all this.
I get it. I quit, but I get it. Oh, look at that. That's hilarious.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Hurry into Toyota's national clearance event. Toyota is the most fuel-efficient full-line car company on the road today. And now's the perfect time to get amazing deals, like Camry, with an impressive 31 mpg highway rating. Or the 2009 Corolla, highway rated at 35 mpg. And while you're there, check out Yaris, with a 36 mpg highway rating. So hurry in and improve your MPG. The Toyota National Clearance Event is on now.
So it's Carlos Marmol in a bases-loaded situation. And I mean, how do you view this if you're Carlos? I mean, it seems like a high-pressure spot here. Bases loaded, nobody out. But the team leads by nine. Do you view it like there's nobody on base? Just go after the hitter. Don't worry about the runners.
Well, I would suggest to Carlos that he throws strikes. Otherwise, he'll get a visit from Lou, and that's the last thing in the world any pitcher on this staff wants right now. Offense has gone through a week of doldrums and finally busted loose with 14 runs on 18 hits. And all you need is three outs to take this one on home. And Michael Wirtz gave up back-to-back hits, and then a walk fell behind every hitter he faced. I mean, Marmol needs an inning of work. It's been 4 days since he's pitched, but I think Lou would have rather saved him till tomorrow if possible.
There's a grand slam by Holbert Cabrera on the first pitch. And now there'll be nobody on base, but after four runs have scored, it's 14-9. Remember, Cabrera came in to pinch run for Encarnacion. That was his first at bat. So they clean the slate. The Reds have scored eight times in the last two innings. One ball, one strike on Jay Bruce. Well, I think Cabrera knew exactly what you said, that Marmol wasn't going to mess around. He was going to throw strikes. Three of those runs charged to Michael Wirtz. And now what Lou's saying to himself is, I don't want to have to get Kerry Wood up. Then as Fontenot will throw out Bruce. There's a big first out. I'll tell you, if the Reds put a couple of guys on, he may have to get Kerry Wood up. Marmol against Corey Patterson. Base hit to right.
Yeah, sometimes the problem you see with late inning relievers, guys who are used to coming in close ball games to nail down a victory or to maintain a tie game, they come into the ball game and they throw pitches without a purpose. Carlos just winging that ball towards the center of the strike zone right now, which is what you're supposed to do, throw strikes, but you still have to throw quality strikes.
Patterson will take second base, probably won't get a steal. Called strike on Bacco. Doubled home two in the eighth. Kick and the pitch. Caught the outside corner. Now that one was with the purpose. Javier Valentin on deck. Strike three. Two down.
And Bacco just frozen on that fastball at the outside corner, a little above the knees.
You know, they had it at 88. Here in the ballpark, looked like it had a little more hop than that. Bottom line is it was well located. Valentin pinch hitting. And I think he just missed it. He did. Coy Hill will go get it. Patterson ends up at third.
He swung and missed, and that ball hit him in the foot.
The wild pitch allowing Patterson to go to third base.
That ball caught him on the outside of the left foot as he finished his swing.
Flails at a slider, 0-2. Carlos seems to have him set up.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Throw him another slider.
Got him. Cubs win. They snapped the six-game losing streak. Reds didn't go down without a fight. But the final score tonight, the Cubs 14, the Reds 9. So the lead remains at 4. They surpassed their win total from 2007. And they're back to 30 games over 500. Well, it wasn't the prettiest win, but the offense is back, and Jason Marquis was tremendous tonight.
Oh, he really was. I didn't think the day would ever come when we said we were glad to see Jason Marquis to take the mound, but he's been throwing the ball that good recently. You just had the feeling he was going to keep the team in the ball game. The question was whether the offense could get untracked against Johnny Cueto, and they got untracked in a big way tonight.
Now the Chevy players of the game. We're going to give it to Alfonso Soriano and Jason Marquis. Soriano tied his career high with 3 home runs. That tied the club record as well. Second time he's done it as a Cub. There was number three, a three-run shot in the sixth inning. And Jason Marquis again went into the eighth inning tonight, and he hit a home run.
Stuff was really good. He knew it. Giovanni Soto knew it. And the Reds discovered it as the game went on.
Let's go down to the field. Chris Bowden standing by with the guy who's pretty happy on his birthday.
Yeah, I think Alfonso Soriano was busy planning your birthday party afterwards, but this is about as good a present as you can get, right? Last a little longer than you wanted, but a good present.
Yeah, we needed this win, and man, can't say enough about Soriano's performance tonight. He just put us on his shoulders, and him and Jason Marquis, you know, we really needed the boost they gave us, and now we can roll.
He's a different kind of igniter at the top of a lineup, usually when you think a leadoff man, but everyone seemed to follow suit tonight.
Yeah, you know, when Sori gets in that zone, he just seems like he gets everything out of the ballpark. You know, it's as simple as that. You know, he ignited us tonight, and we followed his lead.
Have you ever been around anyone who can strike out three times the night before, be in a 6-for-34 slump, and then explode out of it like he does?
That's him. You know, he never loses confidence in himself, and he knows his abilities, and he just goes out there and plays hard every day. And with his talent, you know, you just never know when one of these nights are coming.
We were talking before the game, and you've been in Chicago 5 years now. You know the passion, but you also know sometimes that brings panic. And you said you hear it, but you really don't feel it. Is that one of the benefits of being 35 games above 500 at the time?
Yeah, I think so. I just don't see a reason to panic. You know, we went through this last year in a much closer race, so we have the experience. There's still a lot of games to be played. There's no reason to panic. We have a good team, so you just go out and play. That's all you can do.
All right, thanks a lot. Go celebrate number 33.
I appreciate it.
All right, that's Derek Lee. Four hits tonight. Len, let's send it back to you.
Chris, thanks. Nice job tonight as well. So 14 runs on 18 hits for the Cubs. The Reds, 9 runs on 10 hits, but 8 of those runs came against pretty much the Cubs bullpen late, as only 2 were charged to the starter, Jason Marquis. Had a good night's rest. Come back here, rubber game tomorrow. And Sean Marshall will oppose Aaron Harang before an off day in St. Louis Monday. And the Cubs will start a big 3-game series Tuesday night against the Cardinals. So that'll do it for our game coverage. Stay tuned. Post-game live is coming up next. Once again, the final score tonight, the Cubs 14, the Reds 9. And happy days are here again. The losing streak is over. Again, our next Cubs telecast will be Wednesday night, 7 o'clock Central Time from St. Louis. It's not written in stone, but Rich Harden possibly could return to the Cubs rotation Wednesday night. We'll see. In-game scoring provided by ScorePad. And now for Bob Bradley, Chris Bowden, and our entire crew, Len Casper, saying goodnight from Cincinnati. But stay tuned. We're going to send it over now to Chuck and Kerry in our Comcast Sportsnet studios.
Well, just another one of those ho-hum 14-9 games. Chuck Arfine here with Kerry Sayers in our downtown studios. Coming up next, Lowe's post-game live.
And then be sure to stick around afterwards for the latest edition of Sports Night. A busy day in sports, including the White Sox putting in a little overtime, trying to make it 2 in a row over the Angels and trying to build their lead in the AL Central.
Plus, we go one-on-one with Lovie Smith as he gets set to lead his underdog Bears into the 2008 season with the opener tomorrow night, finally against the Colts.
It's that time. Those stories plus plenty of college football action, including the Illini in action downstate, and the Irish open up their season, need a little fourth quarter comeback to get the win.
But up next, Lowe's post-game live with Gail and the conductor, Dan Plesac. It's up next.
How do you want to see the game? You want to be closer? Well, this is no ordinary ticket. This is your ticket to baseball heaven in high definition. Sharp Aquis, the official HD TV of Major League Baseball. And with a blazing 4-millisecond response time and a super fast refresh rate, there isn't a shot in the hole or a screamer down the line that won't singe the hair in your nostrils. It will change your baseball-loving life.
Aquis LCD TV. Change your TV. Change your life. Sharp.
I am your idea. And I'm huge. Tab me. Bind me. Stack me. Send me round. I'm your big idea. You can't stop this. I'm your biggest idea. And Rico moves me, shows me, sends me. Leaves me behind, but never in a bind. It's the big time. I'm your big idea. Enrico's how we go and go and go. Refreshingly cool taste of the Bacardi Mojito.
I know this drill. I rack up a big charge on my credit card. I get a tote bag.
Well, actually, with our points program, you can get gift cards, flat screen TVs, even plane tickets.
How do you get enough points for that?
Oh, all kinds of ways. By using your debit card, your credit cards, checking account.
I don't believe you.
What?
You're messing with me, right?
No, I'm not messing with you.
Can I still get the tote bag?
Absolutely.
It's not just banking, it's National City.
Cubs baseball on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in part by Southwest Airlines. With Southwest Airlines, you're now free to be more productive. Visit southwest.com today. Menards. At Menards, you'll find big lumber yards, big selection, and big savings. And by your local Chicagoland Buick Pontiac GMC dealers.
The Cubs get a big win in Cincinnati, 14-9. I actually had 14-5 written down, but some unexpected runs by the Reds there in that ninth inning. Still, the Cubs had a great cushion, so they go on to victory and get a much-needed win, evening up this series in Cincinnati. Hello and welcome to Lowe's Cubs Postgame Live. Gail Fisher and Dan Plesac here with you. And Dano, before I get your comments on this interesting game here, it was certainly an offensive barrage from the Cubs. Let's go back and listen to Lou Piniella pregame as he talked about this lineup and who he was going to play.
I'm open to production. That's what I'm open to. I mean, I'm open. We got 21 games left, right?
Yeah.
I mean, the people that are getting the job done are they the ones that are going to be getting the bulk of the playing time? I'm talking about pitching wise and hitting wise. So I have been fair. I've given everybody opportunities all year. This is time now where people that are getting the job done are the people that are going to play. It's plain and simple.
All right, Dan, do words like that spark a team? Some of the players maybe who haven't been producing suddenly step up to the plate and they score 14 runs tonight. That can motivate you a little bit, lose your spot in the lineup.
Well, one thing that Lou is he is a man of his word, and I think he was getting to a point where he was becoming frustrated. You go back before this losing streak started, this was thought of as the best team without question in the National League, and a lot of people thinking it was the best team in baseball, and there's no way that they could have went where they were 7 days ago to being this bad. But one thing that he does do is he knows his roster, and he's not afraid to shake some things up, and something had to be done. We talked about it a little bit on the pregame show. This is too good of a roster to have everybody 1 through 8 collectively go into one of those funks, and sooner or later somebody was going to bust out. And one of the things Alfonso Soriano can do, he can frustrate you for a week to 10 days at a time, but when he gets hot, he gets really hot, and I thank him because we get the dust ahead off. This thing was starting to get cobwebs on, and I was worried about if we were going to get to use it again soon. This is a good team, and they're going to win this division. They went through a tailspin. The big key is going to be getting Zambrano and Harden back healthy. If they do, with about a week to 10 days, and they can get a couple of starts into those two, and they're throwing well, they're going to go deep into October.
Well, Lou must have lit a spark under Alfonso Soriano because he is our Feltco star of the game after having a terrible game last night. He comes out and hits 3 home runs. He was 4-for-5 with 5 RBI. And, Dan, this isn't the only time in his career with the Cubs that he's hit 3 home runs in one game. He did it last year as well.
When he gets hot, Gale, you cannot throw the ball hard enough or low enough where he can't get the head of the bat to it. These pitches really weren't even strikes. These balls were down off the plate, below the knees, but he can some kind of go and get a low pitch, and he can drive that pitch right there. The last home run was supposed to be a fastball up and in, again, about calf high, and he can go get that down and in ball and put a charge in it.
So he sparks the Cubs offense that put up 18 hits and 14 runs in this ball game. And really, when it came down to it, we were looking at two players. Either one could have been player of the game. Alfonso Soriano coming up big on the offensive side. But Jason Marquis also pitching very well for the Cubs tonight. He was a candidate for player of the game. Let's take a look back at our pitching matchup. Here's Marquis in this fourth inning. And Danny got into a little bit of trouble here, but was able to get out of it.
This was really the difference in the game. He's in a situation here with the bases loaded and one out. He gets a big strike out of the pitcher, and now he gets himself into a bind here and a very questionable 3-0 pitch that, in my opinion, was unquestionably a strike. You could see that the hitter right there wasn't even sure. He's standing there, and it was a late call from the home plate umpire, and this was a strike. There's no question about it. Jason Marquis right here loses his composure, but to his credit, he regained his composure, induced a fly ball to left field for the third out of the inning, and he was in complete control of this game from that point on. You see, he runs a fastball in on Kepinger, gets a routine fly ball to left field. There's the hop, skip, and a jump, and really, this game tonight boiled down to two players, Jason Marquis and Alfonso Soriano. Marquis was terrific, gave them 7+, one earned run. He threw the ball extremely well.
As you take a look at the numbers there, 7 1/3 innings for Marquis. He gave up just 5 hits. So another spectacular night for Marquis, who improves to 10 wins on the season. So he gets into that double-digit mark, and he really has been one of the most consistent pitchers lately anyway, especially with the Cubs going through the slump.
Gail, it has never been about the stuff for Jason Marquis. He has very good stuff. He has a low to mid-90s fastball, a good sinking action on his fastball. He has a good changeup, a good tight slider. He just seems to have that one inning where he can't minimize the damage. As opposed to giving up one or two runs, he gives up 3 or 4. He's been doing a very good job of that lately. He's been really good. Tonight, you know, that 3-0 pitch could have led to, you know, him losing his composure. It could have led to a big inning. He stopped it right there. He was really good, and hopefully he's turning that bugaboo around. He's been known as a pretty good first half pitcher. In the second half, things kind of slip away from him. He's been awfully good his last 4 or 5 starts, and it couldn't have come at a better time right now without having Zambrano or Harden. It's putting a lot of extra pressure on the other guys in that starting rotation. Ryan Dempster now jumps to the head of the class as the number one guy, and you'd have to think right now Marquis would fall somewhere in that 2 spot, and it's going to be very big because Sean Marshall is going to be inserted into that starting rotation. If they can weather the storm till they get Harden and Zambrano back, this team will be just fine.
All right, we have to hit our first break, and as we do, let's check out tonight's Buick Pontiac GMC opinion poll question. With a healthy Cubs pitching staff, who would you rather have as the team's 5th starter right now? Is it Jason Marquis, or how about Sean Marshall, who's pitching tomorrow, or a Dan Plesac out of retirement? I think he could give at least a solid 5 innings. Log on to ComcastSportsNet.com, click the link to Chicago, then go to the Cubs page to cast your vote. And we'll have the results later on Lowe's Cubs post-game live.
Yep.
If you missed today's Cubs game, Comcast customers can go to channel 999 and watch Cubs games on Comcast Sportsnet On Demand. Cubs games on Comcast Sportsnet On Demand, only on Comcast, subject to availability.
Can you match this?
Shouldn't be a problem.
Cool.
This?
Yes.
This?
Got it.
This?
Sure. Let me show you.
With our free color matching system, Lowe's can match any color you can come up with or come in with.
This?
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 Absolutely.
And Lowe's carries high-quality Valspar paint. Lowe's. Let's build something together.
This quote of the week is brought to you by Nationwide agent Jeff Vukovich. For an insurance quote for auto, home, life, or business, please call Nationwide agent Jeff Vukovich at 847-825-4783.
It's time to love your carpet. Call Luna for your second room free and a low price guarantee.
Look at you.
Call Luna today and get ready to love your carpet.
773-202 Luna.
Something in the way you move, little darling. Yes, it's something in the way you talk that makes me realize. There's something in the way you move.
The 2008 Volvo XC90 Special Edition SUV. Get together with yours at the Volvo Model Year End Event.
67 with 8 ribbies. Andre Ethier has also driven an 8 while hitting 520. Wow. And Derek Lowe is 2-0 with a 0 ERA over 14 innings. Who's not hot? Ryan Ludwig is scuffling with 11 strikeouts, hitting just 125. Dan Ogla has 8 Ks while going just 5 for 24. And Dan Heron is 0-2 while giving up 10 runs in 10 innings. Welcome back to Lowe's Cubs postgame live. The Cubs get a big victory in Cincy. They needed this one on a lot of levels, and the Cubs getting back to basic fundamentals, some good pitching and some timely hitting, and then, of course, they poured it on offense. Let's take a look back at some quick highlights here. They're trying to break a season-long six-game losing streak. Top of the third, Alfonso Soriano. We see this a lot in this game, Dan, getting on this Johnny Cueto pitch and putting it in the seats.
Dale, when he hits them in bunches, and right here he addresses the ball. Hello, ball.
Boom.
And again, in the top of the fifth, he says hello to this one, an estimated 426 feet. That put the Cubs on top 3-1. Now Soriano faces Jared Burton with two on, a three-run blast for his third home run of the game. That's the hat trick, and it's also 5 RBI. Cubs up 6-1. Mark DeRosa now gets in on the fun. He drills a three-run homer to center. His 20th of the season, the Cubs pound the Reds. Big time, 14-9 is the final. Time now for our Kawasaki Let the Good Times Roll stat of the night. And it really is the Cubs lineup, Dan, because after a while, when I thought it was just Soriano doing all the damage, the rest of the guys got in the act. You see Derek Lee was 4-for-6 with a couple of doubles and 3 RBI. So credit really goes to this entire lineup.
Well, they desperately needed a game like this, and not from just one or two guys. Obviously, Soriano has been the marquee guy of tonight's game. He and Jason Marquis, they were terrific. But up and down that lineup, some good at-bats. They needed to get things turned around, and this is a very good offensive team. And I know that a lot of people have been worried the last three or four games. This is too good of a team to play the way they've played, but it happens, and you get into September. The games are meaningful. They're playing in a ballpark where it's very conducive to scoring runs. The one thing that you could go back in the streak, the starting pitching hasn't been as good as it's been most of the season. And a lot of that has to do with not having Harden and not having Zambrano. Those kind of guys turn that starting rotation over. You get through the 3, 4, and 5, and you put Ryan Dempster in that mix. When those top three are healthy, they're awfully tough to beat. And that's why they haven't had any extended losing streaks. When you have solid pitching, and Jason Marquis, he's been much aligned, but he's about as good in baseball as there is as a fifth starter. He's an accomplished pitcher. He's a veteran pitcher, and he has really stepped it up the last 4 or 5 starts. And they're going to need that until they get Harden and Zambrano back.
Dan, I hate to bring up a negative, but it wasn't really pretty in the end of this game, and that was mainly due to the bullpen that seemed to be a little bit of a sore spot in the end. Jeff Samardzija struggling, and of course we saw Michael Wirt struggle. Lou Piniella a little frustrated in the end of this one.
It is, because when you get to a point of the season now, you'd have liked to have gone through this game tonight and not had to use Carlos Marmol with a day game tomorrow. You would like to give him a couple of days in a perfect world, maybe had him throw a little bit on the side tonight during the game, and now you worry about his availability. You get to this point of the season, you're trying to conserve bullets with your relief pitchers as much as you can, and unfortunately, some of the guys that aren't going to be main members of the core of guys that are going to be pitching the last week to 10 days, they need to step it up. This was a game that I'm sure Lou did not want to bring Marvel into. He had to put a stop to that, to the Reds rally. And it's about winning baseball games. And he had to use Marvel, but I'm sure in a perfect world, he would have liked to have not used him and had him fresh for tomorrow.
Bottom line is, though, the Cubs get the victory. They even this series up, and they stop that six-game losing skid. Still to come on the show, we'll preview tomorrow's matchup with Sean Marshall on the mound.
And now it's time for the Stay in the Game Hold Spotlight, brought to you by Just for Men Hair Color.
But first, as we go to break, here's a look at our Just for Men Hair Color Stay in the Game Hold Spotlight and a look at the National League hold leaders. Cardinals' Kyle McClellan leads the league with 30. Carlos Marmol is second with 25. The D-backs' Tony Pena is third with 23.
Just as these middle relievers keep their team in the game, you too can stay in the game with Just for Men Hair Color.
It's gonna work. I don't think it will. Let's go. Dad?
Hmm?
It's time. You'd be a really nice catch for somebody. Please?
Just for Men takes 5 easy minutes, targets only the gray hair, and can start something great.
For my girls.
Yes! I'm glad we did it.
Just for Men.
I know this drill. I rack up a big charge on my credit card. I get a tote bag.
Well, actually, with our points program, you can get gift cards, flat screen TVs, even plane tickets.
How do you get enough points for that?
Oh, all kinds of ways. By using your debit card, your credit cards, checking account.
I don't believe you.
What?
You're messing with me, right?
No, I'm not messing with you.
Can I still get the tote bag?
Absolutely.
It's not just banking. It's National City.
Nissan set out to create the perfect on-road vehicle, and in the process, created a category. Introducing two crossover leaders from Nissan. The redesigned Murano, awarded as an IIHS top safety pick. And the versatile Rogue, named 2008's best new small crossover. Lease the 27 MPG Nissan Rogue, just $229 a month. Don't follow the leader, own one at your